really test Chelsea Layden today. She really hasn't faced over 30 shots very often this season.
All right. Waiting for the referee at center ice to signal, make sure everything's set to go. He gets the call. Faceoff is dropped, and we're underway here in Hamden. Bobcats get the puck off of the initial draw. Wooster plays it across to Baumgart, trying to play it up. This one intercepted, though, by Desrochers. Desrochers fires, goes wide. Rebound out in front, got deflected by Baumgart. And just like that, early chance there for the Saints. Desrochers, but now here's a chance for the Bobcats to go the other way. Maybe a two-on-one if they hurry, but now they'll get the numbers. So Megan Turner's just going to backhand this one into the zone. Darkangelo now behind the cage of McDonald, trying to chip it out. Comes to the far boards. Can't be held into the zone there by Tamberg. Trying to be played out. Webster can't get a full stick blade on it. And it comes to the Bobcats' own blue line. Darkangelo now from center ice. Going to clear it in. Got deflected a bit there off the stick of Pedalis. Played back around. Connery now on the forecheck. This one gets poked high. Played for Riley Smith. Trying to play it up there with Ranewski. Ranewski drops it off back for Smith. Smith trying to use the speed to her advantage. Centering feed here. Poked away by Nicole Brown for the Bobcats. St. Lawrence still has it. Shot here. Gets blocked out in front off of Connery. Nicole Brown goes into the boards there, trying to battle for the puck. Riley Smith trying to get this one away from Tamberg. Connery trying to use her hands. It's checked a little bit. No call, though, on the play. This one popped up high. And it's going to be gloved down for a hand pass against St. Lawrence. Just about a minute here into the game. Still no score. Both teams, a couple of chances either way.
Yeah, St. Lawrence right off the bat, right first 10 seconds of the game, Desrochers intercepts a pass right across the blue line and skated in for an open shot. So St. Lawrence really putting on the pressure on the Bobcats in the early going.
Wand on the faceoff, wins it for the Saints. Back around, gets dropped off. Ellie Williams trying to be played out in front here for Lund. Lund trying to get it back, goes off the outside of the cage, comes out in front, but there was no Bobcat on the doorstep. Now St. Lawrence in transition, Jackie Wand into the zone, chasing after the loose puck. Wignall trying to battle for it, comes back around behind the cage for Williams, trying to get the centering feed, but this one stolen by Emma Greco for Quinnipiac. Greco now far side, uses the boards to her advantage, trying to play it back around. Worked all the way back for St. Lawrence. Babstock fresh off the bench, can't keep it in. This one cleared down the length of the ice. It's going to be icing against St. Lawrence. 17:56 left to go in the first period. Still looking for the first goal here in Hamden.
St. Lawrence, a team that does well offensively in the first period on the season. 13 goals in the first period. They've shot their most total shots in the first period as well. So look for them to keep up this offensive pressure early.
Face off in the St. Lawrence zone, won by the Bobcats. Darkangelo trying to get the centering feed. It's Megan Turner, her shot. It's deflected wide. It comes to Darkangelo out behind. Using her frame to her advantage, trying to work it back for Babstock, trying to chip it back out in front for Darkangelo. Goes in on goal, a couple players still battling for it, still loose. Sydney Roessler slap shot goes off the outside of the cage and off the backboards. Eventually it'll come to Babstock. Watched there by Ranewski, trying to get the centering feeder for Turner, trying to work it out in front. Again it gets deflected, Darkangelo had a chance at the side of the cage. St. Lawrence having some trouble getting out of their zone. This one can't be held in by Baumgart. After it is Jackie Wand. Jackie Wand going in against Roessler. Wand, of course, towards the end of her shift, so just trying to get the line change for the Saints. Comes to Desrochers in the neutral zone. Tries to play it across. Nice job there to get it to Alex Moore. Moore into the zone. This one calmly guided away by Layden. Moore gets her own rebound, trying to work it back in front. Webster centering feed here. Shot saved by Layden. And she's going to pounce on it, but great chance there for the Saints. Right in the slot, but Layden is there to shut the door.
That was a great job by Chelsea Layden to react to the one-timer from the slot. It looked like taken by Alex Moore. Came back out from behind the boards and sent that one to the opposite side of the goal. So great job by Layden.
Face-off won by the Bobcats. Emma Woods is able to follow this puck and chase it out. Comes to Desrochers. Puts the brakes on out her own blue line, trying to play it back for Wilkinson. Worked up to Alex Moore, but she loses it to Fritz Ward. Fritz Ward skates into the zone, shoots it. McDonald has a little rebound, but she corrals this one back in. 16:38 left to go in the first period. Still no score.
Quick update from Princeton, New Jersey. The Clarkson Golden Knights up 2-0 in the first 3 minutes of the game. So Clarkson really pouring it on in Princeton in the at Friday afternoon matchup.
Face-off, again, won by the Bobcats, but they're not able to get possession off of it. Lindsay West just controlling this one in the neutral zone. It gets played back in for Lund. Hahn has this one. She plays it around for Marks. Marks trying to connect up with Riley Smith. This one cleared all the way down. Tamberg is after it. She has Wernuski right on her back. Tamberg escapes with it, tries to play it up. Into the skates it goes of D'Arcangelo. Eventually it's picked up by Babstock. Babstock still trying to regain control of it. D'Arcangelo in the zone. Looks at her options. She circles, goes to the far side, protecting this one from Hahn. Gets the shot, goes off the outside of the net. This one intercepted by Connery. Nicole Connery looks at her options, gets the centering feed, but Collin couldn't get anything on it. Greco slap shot gets blocked out by Wranuski. Still popped up in the air. St. Lawrence still trying to get it out. Eventually it will come to Riley Smith in front of the Bobcats bench, but as she's tumbling, plays it back to Marks. But the Bobcats controlling much of the neutral zone. Saints are forced to retreat back into their own end. Errant pass there from Lund. Found nobody in particular, but now it comes to Heidersbach. Heidersbach had Ward just in front of her. She was a step offsides. So that'll bring the faceoff out of the Bobcat zone with 15:23 left to go in the first period. No score.
Bobcats really putting on the pressure with the forecheck right there. Put the Saints back with Vonley. Got a lucky pass out of the out of their defensive zone and just a half a step offsides.
Anna Borgfeld trying to get this loose puck, seeing her first ice time of the afternoon. Gets dumped back into the Bobcat zone. Comes to Baumgard, trying to connect up with Fritz Ward. But it eventually comes to possession of the Saints. This one intercepted. Borgfeld has it. Knocked off the puck. She takes down one of the Saints in the form of Wand. St. Lawrence can't get past their blue line, so they're forced to play it back around. Bobcats trying to control much of the offensive pressure so far in this one. Center ice, it's Roessler. Comes to Fritz Ward. She just bangs it in, so the Bobcats are able to get the full line change. Lund has it, trying to get it away from D'Arcangelo. Almost picked off behind by the Bobcats. D'Arcangelo trying to power her way out in front. Babstock chips this one up in the air. Comes back to Turner. She gets it back to the point for West. Trying to get it back to Turner. Turner gets the pass. Shot here. Block receive made by McDonald. Low shot there from Megan Turner. D'Arcangelo now on the far board. Back to the point. Comes across Lindsay West. West shot sticked away by McDonald. Bobcats getting some shots on goal. Battle for the puck now. Escaping with it is D'Arcangelo. West at the blue line just clears it in, trying to go back for Collin. Collin has it. Collin trying to get the centering feed. Connery's backhander just sails over the glove of McDonald. Saints having a lot of trouble getting out of their own zone so far in this first period. Four-player scrum in behind. It comes to Nicole Brown trying to get the centering feed, but overskated a bit by Amanda Collin. It's cleared all the way down. Layden is forced to stop it for Greco. Greco for Brown. Quick chip pass here. Finds Connery. Connery into the zone. Bobcats go for the line change. Woods gets there. This one knocked away by Moore. Popped up. Wilkinson watched there by Woods. Nice sidestep move there by Moore. Eventually it comes to DeRochet. McCray gets it at center ice. This one chipped out. Taken down on the play hard was Webster. She's back to her skate. She seems to be okay. Wignall trying to play this one off the boards for Brackett. Taken by DeRochet, and this one sticked up into the St. Lawrence bench off of the stick of Fritz Ward. Coaching staff of the Saints had to look out on that one. 13:08 left to go in the first period, still no score.
Looking back at that shot by Nicole Connery, just lifting that one over the crossbar, lifted it a little too much with the backhand shot. Would have been a pretty goal if she was able to get it in.
Wilkinson gets the puck, plays it back to DeRochet. Babstock keeps it at the blue line, comes to D'Arcangelo. D'Arcangelo centering feet here for Turner. Turner shot, rebound at the side of the net was Babstock, but flipping out that right pad was Carmen McDonald. She's had to be stellar so far in this one. Roessler gloves this one down, just clears it back in. Alex Moore gets there first. Trying to play it for Hahn. Goes back around for her defensive partner. This one cleared out by St. Lawrence. Losing it a bit there was Wranuski. This one taken by Quinnipiac. It comes from Connery to Brown. Brown's just going to clear this one in. Blocked to the near corner by McDonald. Connery trying to have a nice couple of chances there, trying to escape with it, but it comes to St. Lawrence, and weak attempt there by Smith to play it out. Goes off the skate of Connery. Comes back in to DeRochet. DeRochet loses this one. Trying to play it off the boards as West. Plays it back for Tamberg, eventually for Brown. Brown chips this one by Hahn. Wilkinson trying to beat Emma Woods to the puck. She does. Plays it back to her defensive partner, Bobcats, trying to get a couple of loose possessions of this one. Nice move there by Wand to sidestep it. Having some trouble with the puck so far are the Saints. Fritz Ward, a nice couple of moves there. Into the zone. Fritz Ward puts on the brakes. Plays it back for Brackett. Brackett trying to get the attempt to get around the cage. With fans on the initial attempt. Comes to Wignall. Nice pinch on the far boards. This one trickling out in front. Taken by Desrochers. 11:22 left to go in the first period. Teams still looking for the first one this afternoon. Bobcats take this one. Comes to D'Arcangelo trying to play it up for Babstock, but it gets intercepted by Heidersbach. Back down to the Bobcats' end. Wignall pauses a bit, trying to get some reinforcements on the forecheck. Babstock, nice move there. Kelly Babstock, another move into the zone. Taken down on the play, no call. Trying to get the diving shot off. But a strong defensive play there by St. Lawrence. This one played around. Weak attempt, trying to get out. Eventually it'll be touched up by Lund. Roosler using her strong reach to get this one back. Megan Turner now into the zone. Turner shoots. This one gets deflected and just goes right over the shoulder of McDonald. Almost a fortunate deflection there for the Bobcats.
Megan Turner's had a great start to this game. She's been offensively pressuring Carmen McDonald, gotten a lot of shots on net, and even right there almost got the lucky deflection to find the back of the net, but just missing wide. And, you know, Megan Turner's been a great offensive producer so far.
Baumgard keeps this one into the zone. Comes to Nicole Brown. Centering feed here, trickling in, but held out of the goal by Carmen McDonald. The ever-alert play by the junior goalie for the Saints. Collin forced to retreat after this one. She plays it across the Baumgard. Just deflecting this one is Nicole Brown. Bobcats again going for the full five-line change. This one cleared out by Krakenidis. Touched up. The Saints thought they touched up on it, but it's going to be icing called against St. Lawrence, so that'll bring the faceoff back down by Carmen McDonald. 10 minutes and 8 seconds left to go in the first period. Still no score.
Now the Bobcats going to bring out the top forward line, see if they can try to win this faceoff in their own zone and get it back and take a 1-0 lead.
Faceoff to the left of Carmen McDonald. Alex Moore going to have a whistle on the play. Believe Chris Wells might be going for his timeout here. Tired set of legs, as you said, Kevin, for the Saints, and Coach Rusilli opting out for that fresh set with his first line. And indeed, we're going to have a timeout here for Coach Chris Wells, probably not happy with his team's start so far in this one. Bobcats unofficially out shooting the Saints 7-3, and a lot of the play so far this afternoon has been down by Carmen McDonald.
Yeah, Carmen McDonald really working a lot so far early this season, and in this game, 5-2 on the season, .923 save percentage. Those numbers increasing with pretty much every shot the Bobcats take that she's been able to turn away. So, I think Chris Wells, kind of surprised he's using his timeout here in the first period. You got to think maybe there's another point later in the game that would have been more useful to use it. But, when you feel the time is right, you always got to take the timeout.
Chris Wells coaching his team on what he wants to see them do right coming out of this timeout. Hopefully going to be joined by head coach of the Saints, Chris Wells, up here in the press box after the first period, get his thoughts on his team's season so far and what he thinks his team has done right in this game and what they need to do for the rest of the 60-minute tilt. Horn sounds, so teams will go back to the ice. The Bobcats sticking with that top line of Babstock, Turner, and D'Arcangelo. Roosler and Baumgard holding down the blue line. Faceoff will be to the right of Carmen McDonald. It's going to be Ranewski in against Babstock. Babstock wins it. Weak shot just trickles through the crease. No real danger there for St. Lawrence. Babstock and D'Arcangelo go into the boards against Wilkinson. Desrochers trying to escape with it. She pokes it loose to the far side, trying to get it around Turner. Played it up. Nice pass there to Riley Smith. Smith into the zone, loses it to Sydney Roosler. She plays it off the boards, trying to connect with Kelly Babstock. Babstock's just going to clear this one in. Blocker side away there by McDonald. Baumgard to Roosler. Quick pass trying to connect with D'Arcangelo. Lost it a bit. Wilkinson now trying to play it up. And taking it is Desrochers. Ranewski gets it. Nice job there. Riley Smith gets the pass in between her legs. Works it up to Hahn. Hahn centering feed here. Layden, though, using that active stick and Nice job disrupting the pass. This one popped up high, comes to the near boards. Roessler chipping it out. Borgfeldt now trying to get it in for Emma Woods. Hahn gets there first. Woods pins her to the boards. Lund sending a little bit of a snow shower behind McDonald, trying to put the brakes on. Comes to Heidersbach, knocked down by the Bobcats, and Tamberg just clears it out to Emma Woods. Woods can't get this one around to Fritz Ward, so it comes back in the St. Lawrence zone, trying to play catch with a couple of their players, trying to get the forecheck set up. Jenna Marks trying to get it, intercepted by Tamberg, and she's just going to wrist this one down. Lund gets there to the far side, comes around Ellie Williams. Wignall, though, trying to use her stick to poke this one away. Comes back. Wand plays it back to Lund. Check that. Podalis trying to go after it was Connery. Gets checked there a bit by Podalis, but the Bobcats now escape with it. Connery into the zone. Has room to work with. She shoots. Quick blocker save made there by McDonald. Conlon has it. Trying to work it back around for Connery. Strong defensive play here to keep it in the blue line by Wignall, but it pops in and off of the equipment of Nicole Connery. Webster trying to escape with this one, but it'll be taken by Williams, and she's just going to clear it down. Layden thinks twice about coming out to play it, so it comes to Greco. Brown trying to play it off the board, and now it comes to Babstock. Babstock into the zone. Nice couple of moves there. She's knocked off the puck by Desrochers. Desrochers circles with it. Almost picked off there by D'Arcangelo. And this one eventually is picked off by Sydney Roessler. Roessler into the zone, has a couple players in the slot, but great diving defensive play there by Desrochers to take away the pass. D'Arcangelo now going in against Alex Moore. Moore is eventually able to work it up. And at the red line, it's cleared in by Megan Turner. 7:13 left to go in the first period. Team still looking for their first goal of the afternoon. Getting there first is Ranewski, watched there by Baumgard. Ranewski eventually escapes with it, comes back to the blue line. Can't be played there. A little bit of trouble for Krakenidis. Lund has it. Plays it back for Krakenidis. Quick pass there. Trying to be corralled in. Krakenidis again. Nice move there to get around. Eventually it comes to Lund. Lund has some room into the zone. Lund shoots. Saved by Layden. This one poked out in front. Centering feed here, but Fritz Ward able to get that one away. In the near corner, Fritz Ward going to battle against Riley Smith, trying to play it back to herself off the boards. It comes to Baumgard. Baumgard pinned a bit. Comes to Borgfeldt. She loses an edge, though. She loses it to Heidersbach. Goes all the way around. Heidersbach gets that puck, pops it high up in the air. Comes to Roessler. She's going to play it back. The safe play to Baumgard. Baumgard trying to get the home run pass there to Fritz Ward, but she finds this one go off her skate, so an errant pass on that one. Line change for the Bobcats. Circling with it is Lund. Looks at her options. She plays it over to Marks. Marks touching up this one is Wand, so that'll negate the icing against St. Lawrence. Tamberg trying to get there. Wand can't get everything on this one. Comes all the way to the far side. Colin trying to poke this one out. Lund trying to keep it in, trying to get the pass there to Williams. Williams, weak attempt there to try to get out front. Comes to the near corner. Wand is there. Losing her stick a bit was Lindsay West, but Connery is able to get it back to her. Tamberg in a little bit of trouble. Puts on a couple of moves, eventually try to work it up, but held in by St. Lawrence. Eventually does pop out. Amanda Collin now in a scrum, and it squibs loose to Connery. Connery trying to get the toe drag, deflects this one a bit, trying to be held by D'Arcangelo, and she keeps it to the blue line for the Bobcats. Wignall into the zone, shoots into the glove of McDonald, and she will hold. With 5 minutes and 9 seconds left to go in the first period, Quinnipiac and St. Lawrence still tied at zero.
Good job right there by Shelby Wignall to keep that one in the offensive zone. Just got it right in front of the blue line, was able to wrist a shot. Easy glove save for McDonald.
D'Arcangelo trying to get this one pickpocketed by Brooke Webster. Webster, one of the more potent scorers for the first years on the St. Lawrence team, 8 points on the season, 4 goals and 4 assists. Desrochers works it out in front. Picked off here by Babstock. Babstock shoots. Loud rebound out in front. McDonald having some trouble when it comes to corralling those second chances in. Desrochers back for St. Lawrence. Trying to go far side for Wilkinson. Wilkinson, nice patience, trying to work this one up. Eventually, it will come to Webster. She's going to clear it all the way around. Layden directing traffic. Comes to Emma Woods. Wignall now pins McCray to the board. McCray trying to get this one away from Emma Woods. Gets poked in further. Wignall trying to get this one around. It comes to Greco. And we'll find Olivia Brackett. And Brackett's backhander is just going to go in and out of the Bobcats bench. That'll bring the faceoff back in the Bobcats zone. 4:12 left to go in the first period. Still scoreless.
A lot of neutralized play right there. Bobcats trying to get it out, but Brackett's pass a little errant, so go back into the defensive end. St. Lawrence still looking to get on the board first.
Faceoff here will be taken by the Saints, but Connery tries to get it away from Riley Smith. Comes back around for Baumgard, trying to play it off the boards herself. She's pinned there a bit. Comes to Connery. Connery puts a big check on one of the St. Lawrence forwards. It was Riley Smith. It's going to be body checking, so heading to the box is going to be Nicole Connery. St. Lawrence gets their first power play opportunity of the afternoon, and that was a bit of a dangerous play there if you're Nicole Connery.
Yeah, that was looked like Connery came in with a little too much speed, end up hitting Smith into the board. Smith down for a second, but regained her composure, was able to get back up. So St. Lawrence going to go on the power play, a team that's really struggled on the power play so far this season, as St. Lawrence comes in with a power play percentage of about 16%.
Chance here for St. Lawrence to try to get the first one this afternoon. Ranewski on the near boards, trying to go down low for Webster. Ranewski gets it back. Webster has it, trying to get the shot. Goes off the post a bit. Layden doing a nice job there of closing that opportunity off, and the Bobcats clear it down. McDonald is out to set it up. Saints on the power play for a minute 37 left. 3:29 left to go in the first period. Wignall trying to clear this one out. Gloved down, but eventually it comes poked out to Fritz Ward. Bobcats shorthand opportunity. Fritz Ward into the zone. She has it. She shoots. Rebound out in front, but Collin overskated a bit. And now with numbers the other way is St. Lawrence if they hurry. Heidersbach into the zone. She shoots. Just goes wide of Layden. Fritz Ward going to clear this one out. It'll get knocked down in the neutral zone. DeRochet controlling her troops, trying to get something set up with the man advantage. They have a minute left to work with. Goes into the zone. Wignall is out to try and stop it so she can get the strong clear out. And Wignall has this puck pinned to the boards in between her skate. Digging at it, St. Lawrence. Escaping with it eventually is Wilkinson. Comes all the way around to the near side. Fritz Ward gets it around. Wignall to Roessler. Roessler, though, can't clear it. Gloved down again by DeRochet. Roessler on second attempt. D'Arcangelo trying to backhand this one off the boards. Comes DeRochet, has a lot of time and space to do something with it, trying to get the low chance opportunity there for McCray, trying to bank it home, but she fanned on it. 19 left to go on the power play to the Saints. This one comes out in front. Riley Smith, her shot gets blocked by D'Arcangelo. D'Arcangelo's stick tangled up there a bit with Smith. St. Lawrence trying to get something working down below the goal line. And this one can't be held in by DeRochet. 5 seconds left to go on the kill for the Bobcats. DeRochet forced to retreat a bit, but defensive opportunity here laps. Here's McCray into the zone. McCray has it. She fans on the backhander, and that'll do it. So the Bobcats, strong kill there. And St. Lawrence 0-for-1 on the power play on the afternoon so far. A minute 43 in the period. Here's a chance now on the side of the cage, but Layden has her pad out, and she's going to pounce on this one with that glove. 1:40 left to go in the first period. Teams tied at zero.
Abby McCray missed out on two chances for the St. Lawrence Saints to really get a goal in that period. Whiffed on the shot on the pass from Wilkinson, and then right there the one-on-one opportunity late and missed on that.
Bobcats can't get any forecheck pressure there, just able to get this one out of the zone. St. Lawrence re-ups, trying to get this one. Pedalis tries to play it in. Nicole Brown trying to chip this one around. It comes to Connery. Nicole Connery trying to get skating going. Collin into the zone. Collin shoots, and this one calmly scooped up with the glove by Carmen McDonald.
It's a great drop pass right there from Nicole Connery to create some space for Amanda Collin to get the shot, but, you know, just right at the chest of McDonald. An easy save for her, but, you know, you just got to keep getting those shots on, and eventually they'll go in.
Bobcats have their first line out. It'll be Babstock going in against Brooke Webster. Babstock trying to get this puck out of the faceoff dot. Protecting it is Heidersbach. D'Arcangelo has it, trying to go cross ice for Babstock. Babstock, nice move there, trying to get it back. Loses it a bit. D'Arcangelo had a chance. Babstock now, this puck pops up in the air. Marks plays it back for Pedalis. Pedalis slows things down. Watch there on the forecheck by Babstock. Pedalis skates out. He gets it around D'Arcangelo. Marks trying to play this one around. Baumgard trying to get the edge away of Heidersbach. Babstock will collect this one in her zone. Play it up to D'Arcangelo, trying to connect with Turner. Turner's just going to chip this one forward. 33 seconds left to go in the first period. Babstock can't keep this one. It comes to Desrochers. Desrochers' backhander comes slithering through the neutral zone, but no Bobcat was there to pick it up. North Saint. Tamberg, nice move there to get around. She plays it back to Turner. 18 seconds left to go in the period. Megan Turner, slap shot, guided to the near boards by McDonald. Borgfeld trying to go back around for Fritz Ward. This one intercepted by Wilkinson. Wilkinson trying to get the home run pass there for Riley Smith. 5 seconds left to go in the period. Woods trying to chip this one ahead. It's taken by McCray. She's going to play it back. But the horn will sound, and that will do it for the first period. Teams held scoreless for that one. Both teams, though, had some opportunities. St. Lawrence, some of their best coming when they had their one power play opportunity of the period. Nonetheless, teams head to the locker room 0-0. We're just getting started here on the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network. We will take a quick commercial break, come right back with your first intermission report, and head coach for the Saints, Chris Wells. You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network.
From the outside, the TD Bank Sports Center screams excitement. Inside, it's even louder. It's another season of hard-hitting Quinnipiac ice hockey and red-hot basketball, side-by-side in one of college sports' most amazing venues for fans. Check the schedule and get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. The Bobcats are making some noise this year. Are you? Yeah. Game on.
This is Jack McDonald, Director of Athletics at Quinnipiac University. On behalf of all of our student-athletes, coaches, and parents, we are very grateful to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network for broadcasting all our games all over the world to our Bobcat fans. Thank you, QBSN.
You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network, the official flagship station for volleyball, field hockey, rugby, and men's and women's soccer.
The all-new Bobcat Shop and Simplify Gift Shop by Campus Customs is now open just down the road at 1010 Sherman Avenue. Officially licensed Bobcat apparel and souvenirs in hundreds of styles, also featuring unique Simplify gift items like candy, jewelry, gourmet popcorn, apparel, and much more. Group screen printing and embroidery orders are also available and produced on the premises with low minimums and quick turnaround time. Visit our website at www.thebobcatshop.com.
Hey, Bobcat fans, don't forget to go to www.theqbsn.com for live broadcasts, game stories, pictures, and more. TheQBSN.com offers you everything you need to know about the Bobcat teams you know and love. Again, go to TheQBSN.com, the online home for your favorite Quinnipiac sports.
Hey, Quinnipiac Bobcat fans. This is Billy Mecca from the Bobcat Sports Network. Please join us this season at the TD Bank Sports Center.
Welcome back here to the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network. We're now joined by St. Lawrence head coach Chris Wells. Going to give him a minute to catch his breath as he steps on up here. So again, coach, thanks a lot for coming up talking with us. So after one period, your team and Quinnipiac still held scoreless. What did you see out of your team in that first period that you liked?
Well, let me catch my breath here, jumping
sure,
up on the stairs.
So.
Probably a lot of what this interview is going to be like. I'll catch my breath. It took us a little while to catch our legs and thought that Quinnipiac had a couple of good matchups. Obviously, we want to make sure that we pay extra close attention to Babstock and her line. And we missed out on a couple of matchups there, and I think they capitalized, and Carmen was able to make a couple of good saves. to keep the game 0-0 there early on. And then she made a good save on the two-on-one on the power play. And But all in all, I thought we had a little better second half and had some good chances. But 0-0, probably Vegas wasn't taking any odds on a tie score after the first period against the two of us, right? But you know, I think both teams had some decent chances. We had some had a nice little breakaway there at the end. All in all, I think the shots were I can look at this. I get to look at the million-dollar scoreboard here. We got just about everything. It's like Wally World here. 14-7, I would think probably half a dozen of those shots came with Babstock's line there in that one shift where they had us hemmed in pretty good.
And just talk a little bit, your decision to take that timeout early on is pretty much because your team took the icing. You want to give them a breather on that one?
Yeah, no, we're allowed to make a change on the icing if you call a timeout. You only get one of them, and I think we were looking maybe for a different matchup out there because it was the similar matchup where they had a lot of chances, and I felt like we dodged a bullet. If that group was fresher, I probably would have, kept them out there. But not only was it something that we're trying to avoid, but that group was tired as well. And as we've seen over the last four games between these two teams, goals are an absolute premium. First game of the playoffs, it only took one, so usually wouldn't take one in the first period. But in that situation, I felt like that would be something that we should probably do.
And of course, the last time your team was in this building, you defeated the Bobcats in the quarterfinals last year in that tight three-game series. Just talk a little bit about what your thoughts were on that series as a whole, because pretty much it did come down ultimately to tight defense and as well as the goaltending.
Yeah, I thought both goaltenders were excellent in that series, some timely goals. The two overtime games, and we were fortunate enough to get two quick goals there on the Sunday night, and I think we just kind of rode the wave in. I don't remember us getting too many shots on net in the second and third period, and Quinnipiac came and really took it to us in the second period of that Sunday night game, and Carmen, I think, stopped 15, 16 shots, all quality, and Babstock missed probably four or five chances that she probably doesn't miss very often, so not only were we able to get some early goals and get up on them, we were pretty fortunate that some of the others didn't go in at our end.
And, of course, looking at two of your first-year players who've been pretty much bright spots for you and Alex Moore and Brooke Webster. Just talk a little bit about what they've been able to do so far in their time here as Saints.
Yeah, no, they've been able to jump into our lineup. For freshmen, sometimes you can jump into a team depending on what you lose the year before, and these guys have been pretty fortunate to be able to jump into some pretty cushy spots. The old adage of pay your dues, that type of stuff. I don't think it is as prominent in the women's game because the roster sizes aren't as big as on the men's side. But for what we lost with some of our offense, Brooke and Alex have been able to come in and play some really key roles. I think they both have 8 or 9 points each, and most of those points have come here recently as they've gotten more comfortable with the game. And it's certainly good when you lose Fernandez and Sabatine and Bouye, who is out with a medical redshirt this year. That was almost 100 points just between the three of them. So we've been doing a pretty good job and getting some good depth scoring. And I've been really happy with this team. I've really enjoyed coaching this team. I think that we're going to be one of those teams that continues to improve as the year goes on, as I think we have done in the last couple of years. But because of some younger kids in the lineup and then some other kids who haven't played in key ice time situations the last couple of years because of the kids we had, it's growing situation for us, for them, but they're improving and they're having a lot of fun, and it's been a good group. And this is a big swing weekend. You got the four teams, 3 through 6, all playing each other, and then you guys play Princeton on Tuesday. So there's points, and then there's points plus. This is a points plus weekend for sure.
All right, so just about a little bit before the second period starts, what is something you want to see out of your team, some adjustments you want your team to make coming out into that second period?
Well, I mean, part of the timeout, too, is I just felt like we were a little tentative. We played last week, but it was kind of an off week, so I think mentally we kind of checked out a little bit, which you need, kind of recover a little bit. So, we go from playing Harvard and Dartmouth in the league into two great games up at our place, and then we take, we have 2 weeks of practice with a game up in Canada against McGill, which – it's a game, but certainly didn't carry the intensity that you saw here in the first period. So for us to get out, I was real happy to get out 0-0, quite honestly, because Quinnipiac has really had our number in this building in the first period in a lot of games too. So to get out 0-0, I was pretty happy. So just to get our legs under us, you know, obviously part of that is Quinnipiac pressing us so well, but just to get back into playing, you know, competitive hockey again, sounds kind of simple, but that's it. But, you know, we like to have the puck. We don't like to dump it in a whole lot. We like to regroup it. And I felt like we dumped the puck in a couple of times when we had an opportunity to bring it back to our D and try to strike again. So just kind of getting back into the flow of things, you know. It's kind of like you guys when you come back from vacation. You got to get back into the classroom and get into school, right? You know, so that's what we're trying to do here, and I think we did a pretty good job first period.
All right. Well, Coach, thanks again for joining us up here, and good luck for the rest of the game.
Thanks for having me. You guys do a great job. Every time I come here, this production crew gets better and better. You got, like, you know, you got ground zero down there. I mean, you got like 15 guys doing the production. This is great. Great for the college game. Great that you guys are doing it for women's hockey to get our game out there, because it's a great game.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Coach.
Going to now bring on Kevin Noonan, who was standing to my left during that nice little interview there with Chris Wells. Great coach, one of the great coaches, not only in the ECAC, but the country as well. You know, he loves the game of hockey. He loves his team, and just always a great around guy trying to spread the word there for women's ice hockey, because as he said, it is a great sport. And to get praise, of course, from another ECAC coach as well, certainly is a pat on the back that we like to take as well. But in between all of that, there was a first period of hockey that was played between the Bobcats and the Saints. 0-0. Bobcats pretty much with the better of the play for that period. If taking a look at the stat sheet now, as again, Bobcats 1-for-1 on the penalty kill, outshooting the Saints 16-4. And as you heard Coach Chris Wells allude to, maybe a little bit too much dumping and chasing. We saw the Saints try to allude to the fact that Coach Wells likes his team to regroup, not dump and change it. We saw Mel DeRocher certainly try to do that with her teammates as well. But Carmen McDonald, the busier of the goaltenders, and pretty much she's the reason, Kevin, why pretty much here still scoreless.
Yeah, definitely. I think Carmen McDonald, just like last year, she's done a great job of keeping the Saints in this one. She hasn't even looked like she's had trouble with any saves. She's kicked out a few too many rebounds, but her team's right there regrouping and able to clear the puck out. So I think that McDonald definitely doing a great job in goal for St. Lawrence. And I mean, you said it right. Without her, this could probably be a 1-2 game for Quinnipiac, between the opportunities from Nicole Connery, and Megan Turner's had a few, and Kelly Babstock's been right there as well. So this offense for the Bobcats really putting a lot of pressure on St. Lawrence. And in the first period, that's really not something St. Lawrence is used to. They're used to really kind of controlling the play in the first period.
Indeed. And just about 4:14 now since until we start the second period. If you're on the St. Lawrence side of things, Kevin, your Coach Wells, what are you telling your troops? What do you want to try to do early on in the start of the second period to sort of slow the game down and start turning the tide towards in your favor?
Well, I think now that Coach Wells said it, I think that now that they've got their legs underneath them, they played a better second half of that first period, and I think things will start going their way. They had that power play, that quite a few opportunities on the power play to really get a goal. The best opportunity came when Abby McRae fanned on that shot. She was wide. She was all alone at the bottom of the faceoff circle, and then right at the end, as the penalty expired, McRae had that one-on-one opportunity with Chelsea Layden, where she kind of lost control of the puck. So I think that they're starting to play better hockey as that period wound down, and I wouldn't be surprised if it carried over. I mean, as I said before the game started, this team needs to put pressure on Chelsea Layden. Layden hasn't faced a lot of shots this season. There's been games where she's made 28 saves, but for the most part, it's been high teens, low 20s, and I think St. Lawrence just has to get the puck on net and really just make Chelsea Layden work, and I think we're going to see St. Lawrence do more of that in the second period, but I certainly am not surprised with the 0-0 score so far.
Yeah, and certainly a game that St. Lawrence wants to keep an eye on while they're here in Hamden is Clarkson and Princeton, already underway in Princeton, New Jersey. At last check, the Clarkson Golden Knights had a 4-0 lead on the Princeton Tigers as well. St. Lawrence traveling to Princeton tomorrow, and Clarkson traveling up here to Hamden for another afternoon game for all these women's teams. But as you know, Kevin, as Coach Wells said, you look at the standings right now for the ECAC. Cornell's at the top with 14. Harvard is 13 behind them. And then Quinnipiac, Princeton, and St. Lawrence all tied with 8 behind them. So pretty much when it comes to these ECAC games, as he said, it's pretty much a 4-point swing. Either way, you roll the dice. And as it comes down to it, it's the Bobcats trying to set themselves up, trying to get one of those top spots in the ECAC. They were picked from about middle of the pack in the preseason rankings, but you know, as it stands right now for the Bobcats, they have two ties in the league, a 0-0 tie against Yale, which, you know, could have been a win if you're the Bobcats, you say that. And then as well, they were pretty much on their way to defeating Cornell, but came to a penalty shot. Chelsea Layden happened to kick it into her own cage. They tie Cornell 1-1 back when Cornell was ranked high tops in the country as well. And, you know, coming off a weekend sweep of Boston College and UNH, I think pretty much the emotions and the confidence for this Bobcats team as they continue on into league play, they got to certainly be running high.
I mean, you can't even forget about Clarkson when you go talk about those standings. Clarkson just behind those three teams at 7 points. And as Coach Wells said, a points plus weekend because you have Quinnipiac and St. Lawrence here, Princeton and Clarkson down in Princeton, New Jersey. The Clarkson coming here and St. Lawrence going down there. And then Princeton hosting Quinnipiac on Tuesday. So, as he said, this is going to be a big weekend where you could see a shakeup in the middle part of the standings. But, you know, we're only in November. I don't think it's something to be too concerned about just yet. But, you know, Quinnipiac's been riding high, especially after that Hockey East win, those two Hockey East wins. They haven't exactly, they didn't play their best hockey last weekend, but they played well enough to beat a team like Boston College, who was 5 in the country. And then the University of New Hampshire, another team that was, they weren't ranked, but that team, a very talented team that did beat Boston College. So, I mean, that was a big win for, two big wins for Quinnipiac to get last weekend. And, you know, certainly gave them all a momentum. Not that they've had any changes in momentum since the season began.
And certainly it is indeed the month of November. Pretty much every male up here in the press box sporting facial hair for No Shave November, except for Zachary Daly, because he can't grow any facial hair. But that's either here nor there. Teams back out onto the ice for the second period. St. Lawrence in their red jerseys, Quinnipiac in their alternate whites. Carmen McDonald to our right, Chelsea Layden to our left. Teams primed for the faceoff here to start things off, the second period. Again, you're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network. Peter Rossi joined by Kevin Noonan. 0-0 score. Kelly Bastock going in against Abby McCray. Waiting for the official time to come up on the million-dollar scoreboards, as Chris Wells like to call it. Wally World here in Hamden, Connecticut. Comes back to Sydney Roessler. Quickly plays it up to Babstock. Kelly Babstock, shot, gets blocked away by Wilkinson. D'Arcangelo trying to connect with Babstock out behind. Went to nobody in particular. Comes all the way around. McCray trying to battle this one out. Loses it, though, to Sydney Roessler. Forced to be played back by Wilkinson. Wilkinson trying to connect with McCray. Playing this one off the boards, past the red line. Racing after it is Taryn Baumgart. She will get there first. So a early icing here against the Saints, just about 30 seconds into the second period.
And when St. Lawrence puts this line out with, or this defensive pairing with Wilkinson and DeRoche, it's pretty much like they have five forwards out there on the ice, because DeRoche and Wilkinson with that strong offensive ability.
Off the faceoff, Bobcats will try to retain possession of it. Connery playing it back. Wilkinson, though, will take it. She's met by Collin, but Wilkinson, strong play to lift the stick there of Amanda Collin. Brown trying to get this one around. DeRoche has it. Trying to get the short pass there just to the side of the net. McCray can't corral it in. She eventually gets her own rebound, forced to play it back to Wilkinson. This one hits the linesman from DeRoche. St. Lawrence gets the partial forward change. Wilkinson and DeRoche, long shift here. This one gets touched by Riley Smith, so Wignall is forced to go after it, drop it off for Tamberg. Playing it up for Brackett. Brackett gets this one intercepted. Tamberg again gets it to Brackett. Off the boards, it comes to Fritz Ward. Morgan Fritz Ward in the zone, shoots, rebound out in front. Backhander into the glove there of Carmen McDonald. But again, Kevin, rebound control going to be a little bit of an issue so far here this afternoon for McDonald.
Right there for McDonald, the rebound going out, but Fritz Ward with really no angle to get a second shot on goal. She hugged the post pretty well.
Faceoff will be taken by St. Lawrence. Riley Smith trying to protect it away from Fritz Ward. Played back for Pedalis. Pedalis playing a little bit of a catch there with Jenna Marks. It played up, and it's taken now by Ranuski. Ranuski into the zone. Shot gets deflected. Layden watches this one just go by her cage. Ranuski again, trying to get the centering feed. It finds it. Rebound out in front. Marks had the shot, but blocked away by Fritz Ward. Strong defensive play. Still in the zone now. Bobcats forced to chase after it. Greco trying to play this one out. Brackett trying to outstretch and get anything on that one. Taking a tumble, though, was Riley Smith. Bobcats look to get the counterattack going, but they go for the line change. Babstock line back out. Babstock trying to steal this one away. D'Arcangelo has it. Centering feet here in on. Goes off the inside of the post there from Babstock. Was able to get that puck under Carmen McDonald, and the Bobcats almost got the first one of the afternoon on that one.
Great play made by Babstock right there, and D'Arcangelo.
Baumgard in a little bit of trouble there behind her own net. This one popped out into the center. Wand can't get everything on it. This one taken by DeRochet. Nice job there, working across, shot here. Rebound out in front, gets poked into the crease, but it will be taken by Babstock. Babstock, here's a two-on-one now for the Bobcats. D'Arcangelo into the zone, shoots in and out of the glove of McDonald. So two-on-one opportunity there for the Bobcats. D'Arcangelo trying to put a little show of speed on, was able to get around the defense, but a nice opportunity there again for the Bobcats. Connery, hard pass, trying to get this one, work it back around. She does get it to Lindsay West, playing it up here to D'Arcangelo. She fans on the initial pass, trying to get it to Connery. Can't get anything on it. West playing it across for Colin. Colin, fresh off the bench, trying to protect it, plays it off the boards to herself. Centering feed here for Colin, trying to play it to Brown. Brown centering feed, but no Bobcat was there. 16:25 left to go in the second period. No score still between the Saints and the Bobcats. This one popped up. Knifed down by the Bobcats. Can't be held in. Almost, though, by Williams. This one played back to Krakenidis. Krakenidis trying to play it up. McCray, bouncing puck she had to deal with. Riley Smith trying to get around Lindsay West. Tamberg almost losing this one, but she's able to chip this one ahead for Amanda Collin. Collins' pass gets intercepted by Ranewski. Ranewski in the near corner, protects, trying to work it back around. Nice drop pass there. Centering feeder for St. Lawrence. Shot, save made by Layden from Ranewski. And a strong opportunity there for St. Lawrence. Bobcats having some trouble getting out of their own zone now. And that's going to be a penalty. And it's going to be on Amanda Collin. McDonald trying to get to the bench for the extra attacker. She gets there, so it's a 6-on-5 now in favor of St. Lawrence. Alex Moore trying to play this one. It's a delayed offside call against St. Lawrence. Heading to the box is Amanda Collin. Coach Rick Seely not happy with the call. Certainly giving the referee a mouthful. It's going to be tripping against Amanda Collin. St. Lawrence back to the power play. 15:19 left to go in the second period.
On that play, it looked like Amanda Collin just kind of in the wrong spot at the wrong time. The skate just in the way. And unfortunately for her, it gets the tripping penalty.
And it seemed as if Collin knew that she had a player coming behind her, and Collin looked out of the corner of her eye and at the last second stuck that leg out. So certainly that is probably why she got the tripping call. Nonetheless, Bobcats back on the penalty kill. They're 1-for-1 so far in the afternoon. Here's a chance now for St. Lawrence. McCray into the zone. Plays it around. Alex Moore trying to slow it down for her point partner in Wilkinson. Comes all the way back around for Greco. Greco trying to use the boards. She gets it all the way down. D'Arcangelo, though, going to get there first. D'Arcangelo has it. Centering feet here. Comes in front. Save made by McDonald. Still poking away at it is Babstock, and maybe a quick whistle on that one. And Coach Rick Seely still giving the referee a piece of his mind on that tripping call to Amanda Collin. But another chance out in front. Almost goes in on McDonald. Would have been shorthanded for the Bobcats. And
we've covered it up just long enough to get the whistle.
14:30 left to go in the second period. 1:09 left to go on St. Lawrence's power play. Comes into the zone for Webster. It'll be taken by Fritz Ward. And this puck will be popped into the St. Lawrence bench. And Chris Wells has himself a souvenir.
Quinnipiac's penalty kill on the season. Now 45 of 50, getting right around that 90% mark. Done a great job so far this season. The power play for St. Lawrence now 11 for 66 on the season. That'll drop them just under 16%.
Face off. Fritz Ward going against Ranewski. Be won by Ranewski. This one gets deflected up high. Roessler trying to go down on one knee to stop it from going any further into her own zone. She's watched there by two Saints players. Roessler takes down player in front of her with a strong defensive play. Roessler now pinned to the boards. Strong play by Heidersbach. This one trying to be gloved down. It comes to Fritz Ward. Fritz Ward into the zone, shorthanded. Her shot popped up, deflection off of the stick there of McDonald. Another rebound attempt. Strong penalty kill here so far for the Bobcats. They have 24 seconds left to deal with. Tamberg trying to poke this one out. Going to be offsides against the Saints. So St. Lawrence with some early pressure on this power play, but since then not being able to get anything going in the Bobcats' defensive zone.
Yeah, and after that, another rebound given up by Carmen McDonald. You have to start thinking, if you're the Bobcats, maybe park someone more in front of McDonald to clean up those rebounds that she's letting squeak out.
Shorthanded, here's Kelly Babstock trying to get around DeRochet. Pass here into the zone. Wignall, defensive play, trying to prevent any chance there, trying to come from Bell. Sydney Bell back around, can't get the puck. Comes to DeRochet. She's watched there, comes in on goal. Rebound, score! Riley Smith on the doorstep. Gives St. Lawrence the 1-0 lead. Defensive breakdown hurts the Bobcats. But St. Lawrence will get the first of the afternoon on the power play.
Great job right there by Riley Smith. Right in front, able to tuck that one in. It was a matter of time before St. Lawrence was able to take advantage of one of those opportunities on the power play. And right there, right at the end of the power play, might have expired just before the end of it. But, you know, St. Lawrence gets that early advantage.
So the Bobcats now trying to come back and tie this game up. Shot here by Sydney Roessler pops out in front. McDonald got a piece of it. This one intercepted by Quinnipiac. Can't be held in by Connery. She's going to circle in the neutral zone and play it up to Amanda Collin. She's going to backhand it into the zone. Wilkinson trying to get this one away from Connery. Comes to Hahn. And Hahn is able to get it out of her zone, but taken by Quinnipiac. West trying to connect with Woods. Woods trying to get there. Wilkinson, though, puts on the nice move to circle around with it and get it out. Layden is out to slow it down. It comes to Lindsay West, but miscommunication there as this one's going to go down the length of the ice. And Krakenidis is going to get there and touch up with it, so it's going to be icing against the Bobcats. 12:28 left to go in the second period. St. Lawrence up 1-0.
This is an important part of the game, too, now with St. Lawrence taking that 1-0 lead. You're going to see how both teams come out after it. If you're Quinnipiac, you have to come out firing, ready to go. But if
there first, plays it around for Krakenidis. Krakenidis looking at her options, trying to play it for Webster. She works it to McCray. It's going to be a 2-on-1 here for St. Lawrence if they hurry. McCray, chance out in front here. Save made by Layden. And then Layden gets taken out after she made the initial save by Megan Turner. But Layden is up. She seems to be okay.
But does Megan Turner.
But Megan Turner completely vaulted into Chelsea Layden after Layden made the initial save on the 2-on-1. But some scary moments there if you're Coach Rick Seeley, seeing two of your best players collide and then go into the net.
Well, fortunately for both of them, it looked like Layden was aware. They were both aware of where they were going, and Layden was able to kind of duck, and Turner looked like she was trying to go up and over, so lessen the collision.
Here's Tamberg trying to get this one to Borgfeld. Babstock on the forecheck trying to take this one away. Comes to Alex Moore. Alex Moore into the zone, gets the cross ice pass here. Shot, save made by Layden up high, and she will hold. So St. Lawrence now seems that they found their legs. They're starting to put some pressure on against the Bobcats.
Yeah, I was just going to say that, Pete. St. Lawrence really starting to amp up the pressure and really start firing pucks. Layden, great job coming up to make the high save. And, you know, St. Lawrence looks like they have a little extra pep in their step now.
Connery pins this puck in between her skate at the faceoff dot, trying to play it around for Greco. Greco trying to work it up to Amanda Collin. It'll be taken by Connery. Connery trying to skate into the zone. She does get there, trying to put the brakes on. She's held there a bit. And we're going to have a delay penalty call here on St. Lawrence. It's going to be holding. So the Bobcats now, their first power play opportunity of the afternoon, heading into today, 19.3%, 11 goals on 57 opportunities. But you look at this team on paper, Kevin, and certainly Rick Seeley has a lot of talent to work with when it comes to the man advantage.
Yeah, they have a lot of offensive weapons due to the Bobcats. I mean, you have D'Arcangelo, Babstock, and Turner alone, which would be your first line, but throwing Emma Woods out there with the first power play unit.
So the Bobcats now set up. Roessler at the blue line, looking at her options. Goes far side for Emma Woods. Plays it back for Roessler to Baumgart. Baumgart plays it back to Woods. Trying to go down low for Babstock. Babstock trying to work it out in front for Woods in the slot. She can't get it. This one pickpocketed, though, by Emma Woods. Spins around with it. Off the boards. Back to the blue line for Baumgart. Baumgart for Roessler. Roessler, wrist shot. Almost deflected by Babstock. Held there by Baumgart. Off the boards. Far side for Babstock. Reaches back for Baumgart for Roessler. Roessler observing her options yet again. Trades spots. Cross ice. Score! Kelly Babstock on the power play. Knocks this game at one apiece off of the cross ice feed by Sydney Roessler.
Wow, what a beautiful goal by the Bobcats on the power play. Sid Roessler held that puck for quite a while on the right point. Skated in towards the faceoff dot. Wristed the pass across the ice. And Kelly Babstock with the monstrous one-timer and absolutely destroyed the puck past Carmen McDonald. There was nothing she could do about that one.
So wow. Kelly Babstock, her 22nd point of the season, 10th goal. Bobcats now 1-for-1 with the man advantage. All attack time pretty much for Quinnipiac on that one. And this game is knotted up now at one apiece. 10:17 left to go in the second period. Connery intercepts this one. Could be a chance for the Bobcats. Connery trying to get it out in front for Collin. Popped up high in the air. Nicole Brown has it. Can't corral the rebound, and it comes now for Webster. Webster can't get this one around. Kristen Tamberg. And Tamberg after the play. Tamberg and Moore tied up a little bit with their sticks. All deemed legal by the officials. And now we will see how St. Lawrence responds after letting up a goal. Connery tripped up a bit. Comes to Lund. Krakenidis trying to play it around. Bracket for the Bobcats in the zone. Plays it off the boards. Trying to get her own rebound. Poke it away from Krakenidis. Emma Woods now battling for it. Emma Woods escaping with it. Centering feed here for Fritz Ward. She was down on one knee trying to get the low shot. But defensive play there by the Saints allowed them to take it away. But now Woods drops it for Fritz Ward. Fritz Ward into the zone. Shoots. Rebound out in front. No Bobcat, though, was on the doorstep. Here's a chance the other way. St. Lawrence, Hahn into the zone. Hahn puts on the brakes. She loses the puck, though. Centering feet here. Brackett just watches this one go right by her. To the blue line now. Marks has it. Shot goes off the outside of the cage. Probably hit the low post. Fritz Ward checked heavily on that one. Action seems to be picking up in this one. Both players knock into the near corner. Marks shot. Saved by Layden off the pad. And it comes to Wignall. Wignall touches it up to Brackett, and she will just dump it down. Bobcats again, top line, getting it back out. 8:37 left to go in the second period. 1-1, here's the score in Hamden. Turner trying to play it back around for Babstock. Babstock, nice possession there, taken down a bit, right back up to her feet, still trying to get possession of it. It comes to Roessler. Roessler, wrist shot, gets blocked out in front. Backhander, no look, trying to get it on goal. Comes D'Arcangelo, almost had another chance, but this one swiped away by Hahn. Roessler trying to get the deflection there off of Turner, parked in the crease. Comes back to Roessler. Roessler trying to get the deflection chance there from Turner, far side. Turner gets it back to the blue line. Baumgart, slap shot, rebound out in front, and this one's going to be covered by McDonald, but the Bobcats seem to have been woken up by that power play goal from Kelly Babstock.
The Bobcats continue to put the pressure on. Right there, great save by Carmen McDonald. Stretched the pad out to make the save, and then the rebound kicked out a little bit, but was able to cover it up. McDonald still giving up quite a bit of those rebounds, though.
Quick shot there from the faceoff circle. Gets knocked down by Williams out in front. This one skyhooked into the neutral zone. Be gloved down by Lindsay West. DeRochet slows it down. This one almost pickpocketed by Nicole Brown. Wilkinson now looks at her options. She plays it up for Williams. Williams into the zone. Just clears it around Tamberg. Lindsay West loses this one. Connery now trying to poke it away. Amanda Collin trying to play it. She gets it up to Nicole Brown. Nicole Brown takes the shot. Rebound off the skate there of Wilkinson. And St. Lawrence now looks to get on the attack. Drop pass here. Shot from Williams. Sails wide of Layden. Loud rebound. Could be a favorable bounce here for the Bobcats. Woods into the zone. puts on the brakes. Backhand to the blue line for Wignall. She keeps it, plays it across for Greco. Greco, slap shot there, gets blocked down. Weak attempt, can't get out. Greco, another chance, just goes wide. Krakenidis might have gotten a piece of that one to deflect it. Turner now trying to keep this in. Borgfeld knocked down at center ice by Greco. Comes to Fritz Ward playing it for Borgfeld. Wrist shot into the glove of McDonald. No real difficulty on that one. And that'll freeze play with 6:41 left to go in the second period. Quinnipiac and St. Lawrence tied at one.
Ever since that Quinnipiac goal, the majority of the play has been down in the Bobcats offensive end. St. Lawrence really having trouble getting the puck out, and even when they do get a little bit of a clearance, Quinnipiac's right there on the forecheck to keep it in.
Babstock in the slot trying to get the shot off. Checked a bit. So the Saints responding well with their defense. Brackett can't get this one. This one blocked out in front. A slow trickler went by Layden. Nice job there by the Quinnipiac defense to tie up the Saints players. Brackett easily bumped off of this one. Comes back for more. More into the zone. This one sticked away by Wignall. And it comes eventually around. D'Arcangelo can't get everything on it, so it comes to Pedalis. Wignall trying to take this one again. Comes to Babstock in her own zone. Trying to play this one out. Being held at center ice by Park. She plays it back for Pedalis. And here it comes to Riley Smith. Riley Smith, slap shot into the glove of Layden. And she will hold on. 5:57 left to go now in the second period. Quinnipiac 1, St. Lawrence 1.
Chelsea Layden all ready for that one. Fairly simple save for her as St. Lawrence starting to put a little bit offensive pressure back on the Bobcats.
Face-off won by St. Lawrence. Comes back to the blue line for DeRochet. Trying to play it back. Shot gets deflected there. Chance out now for the Bobcats if they hurry. Nicole Brown has it. This one poked away. Connery hooked there a bit. Eventually took the stick away from Riley Smith. Roessler plays this one in. Off the stick of Brown. DeRochet is there. Collin trying to keep this one in. Roessler just playing this one into the zone. Connery has it to the blue line for Baumgard. Baumgard fakes the shot, but she's not able to keep this one in. Trying to pull the wool over the eyes there of the linesman, but wasn't successful.
Yeah, it was not successful at all. It didn't trickle too much over the blue line, but you know, just enough so that the linesman was able to recognize that, and you know, I don't think he's going to fall for that one today.
So Quinnipiac is able to get this puck back down into the St. Lawrence zone. Comes to Wilkinson, gets this one around Fritz Ward. Tamberg, though, in the neutral zone, bumped a bit. Riley Smith playing it back to Ranewski. Ranewski checked by Tamberg. It comes for Lindsay West. Lindsay West all the way around, and it is able to get out of the Bobcats' end. DeRochet circles with it, trying to be picked off by Quinnipiac. Racing after it's Wignall. She will get there first, and it will be icing against the Saints. 4:53 left to go in the second period. St. Lawrence, one goal thanks to Riley Smith. The Bobcats, one goal thanks to Kelly Babstock.
Yeah, those two goals really kind of woke up both teams offensively, and the intensity of the game hasn't slowed down since then.
Bobcats trying to keep this puck in. Turner has this one tangled up in her skates. It slowly comes out to Wignall. She's just going to clear this one back in so the Bobcats can try to keep the forecheck. Through the zone, the pass comes to Hahn. Hahn trying to connect with Ranewski. We had one linesman saying it was icing, the other one saying it was not. Eventually gets waved off. This one almost picked off by Heidersbach. It comes to Babstock. Babstock has one man to beat into the zone. Kelly Babstock shoots up high. Rebound just dropped. Babstock almost got a chance at it, but this one swiped right out of the danger zone. Heidersbach circles with it in her zone, trying to get it away from Babstock. Nice couple of moves here. And it's going to be offsides as losing an edge was Wand, and she fell into the zone just before that puck happened to go in.
She was aware that she was going to be offsides, tried to slow it down, but kind of, as you said, lost an edge, fell over the blue line. And at that point, it looked Heidersbach recognized that there was probably no way she was going to slow down her momentum and just took the offsides and gets the faceoff right outside of the blue line.
Faceoff here for St. Lawrence. Pedalis plays it back for Marks. Marks trying to get the stretch pass connection in with that one, but Roessler gets there first for Quinnipiac. Another icing against St. Lawrence.
You know, P, one thing that's awesome to see at a school like Quinnipiac is the athletes supporting each other. last night you saw a few women's hockey players and Rick Seeley at the men's soccer NCAA tournament game at UConn. Now today, a few men's soccer players here returning the favor, as well as assistant basketball coach Scott Burrell.
Chance here, Connery's backhander trickles wide. Chance out in front here for Brown. Just went, goes past her. Comes back for Marks. Marks slowly trying to get it around. It comes to Roessler. Roessler's shot gets deflected. Comes back out for McCray. McCray has this one poked away by the Bobcats, but still trying to retain possession of it as Webster. And Webster goes hard into the boards there with Collin. Collin is a bit slow to get up. Eventually she does, though. But St. Lawrence has the puck. Back around behind for Webster. Checked there by Collin. A little bit of a slash on the hands. Shot here from the point. Rebound out in front for Layden. She made the initial save. Couple players now still trying to get it. And escaping with it will be Baumgart. 2:58 left to go in the second period. Teams tied at one. This one gloved down by Lund. She eventually plays it up. Shot here goes wide. Rebound off the backboards. Falling down, centering it, was St. Lawrence, but Quinnipiac able to get it out. Nice job there by Ranuski to try and play it out in front. Roessler and Hahn exchange a bit of shoves there as Roessler heads to the bench. Borgfeld against the boards. Emma Woods trying to get this one out. Shot here, this one off of the skate of Baumgart. Shot here, another deflection off of the Quinnipiac defense. Baumgart trying to go high off the boards and out. After it is Wilkinson. She has Emma Woods right behind her. Emma Woods trying to get this one away. Wilkinson plays it to Desrochers. Desrochers trying to get it now away from the forecheck of Babstock. Babstock knocks this one down, trying to use her skate to work it out in front. Babstock tumbles down a bit, but it comes to Turner. Turner, thinking Babstock was still there, plays it around. D'Arcangelo trying to pressure the Saints into playing this one into a territory that the Bobcats could use. Turner, nice move there to get it around. 1:48 left to go in the second period. Babstock pins this puck to the boards, waiting for Turner to come and help her out. Four-player scrum there. Babstock chills, trying to get possession of it. It comes around the far corner for D'Arcangelo. Backhander to the blue line for West. Plays it across for Tamberg. Tamberg, wrist shot, gets deflected. Babstock cross-checked in front of the net. No call. This puck pops up high into the glass. D'Arcangelo trying to get it. She's in a battle there with Ranuski. It comes out of the zone. Lindsay West is after it. She has Jacqueline Wand, but eventually comes to Tamberg. Tamberg plays it up for Collin. Collin loses it a bit, playing it from her skate to her stick, but this one is intercepted by Desrochers. Nicole Brown, though, keeps it in. Three Bobcats going after the puck. Some miscommunication on that one. And St. Lawrence takes advantage. They clear it out, but Greco has it, getting it to Connery. Backhand into the zone. It'll be taken by Podalis. Final minute of play in the period. 52 seconds left to go. 1-1 between the Bobcats and Saints. This one deflected a bit. Knocked off there by Connery. Connery trying to protect it. She goes down, holding the stick there, a bit of Desrochers. And taking it is Heidersbach, trying to connect with Wand. Greco will get there. Greco taken down a bit. Borgfeld plays it back to Roessler, and she gets it up to Emma Woods. Emma Woods into the zone, trying to get it to Connery. Woods gets the rebound, shot just trickling. Goes in and out of the glove there of Podalis. She's able to get it back to her forward. 20 seconds left to go. Woods trying to get it at the blue line. Greco slap shot gets blocked out in front. Webster now for St. Lawrence, far side. Gets it past Greco. Into the corner it comes for Williams. Williams trying to get it back for Webster. 4 seconds left to go in the period. Webster trying to connect back to the blue line, but Fritz Ward will skate this one out. The horn will sound, and that will do it for the second period. Each team getting a goal in that one, so they will head to the locker room tied at one apiece. We will take a quick commercial break here on the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network. Come right back with your second intermission report and a look ahead to the third period. You are listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network.
Hey, Quinnipiac Bobcat fans. This is Billy Mecca from the Bobcat Sports Network. Please join us this season at the TD Bank Sports Center for some excellent men's and women's basketball and ice hockey games. The TD Bank Sports Center is the best facility in college athletics, as it features family-friendly seating, prices, dates, and times. Please call area code 203-582-3905 or visit QuinnipiacBobcats.com to order your tickets now. Go Bobcats! Peace!
Hey, Bobcat fans, follow us on Twitter and Facebook for daily updates, reminders, and more from the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network, the online home for your favorite Quinnipiac sports.
Saturday night is hockey night here on theQBSN.com. Tune in at the conclusion of every Saturday men's or women's hockey broadcast for Hockey Night in Hamden. Join QBSN's finest hockey broadcasters, writers, and analysts as they break down the weekend that was Quinnipiac ice hockey. Discussions, debate, arguments, and the occasional five for fisticuffs all in a one-hour program live at theQBSN.com. Want something debated during the program? Well, email us at hockeynightinhamden@gmail.com or tweet at HamdenHKYNight. When overtime just isn't enough, we've got your extra hockey. So join us at theQBSN.com Saturdays following the last hockey broadcast for Hockey Night in Hamden, your exclusive Quinnipiac ice hockey talk show.
Ray and Mike's Deli, the deli destination for Quinnipiac athletics. Come and try the new Quick Witch, named for Hamden's own Jonathan Quick. Also the fan favorites, the irresistible Mac Daddy and Steak and Cheese. Come in before or after the game, located at 3030 Whitney Ave. Cue cards are accepted. You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network. Check us out at theQBSN.com for game recaps, previews, feature articles, and so much more. Your internet home for all things Quinnipiac athletics, theQBSN.com.
I'm Matthias Gauss, and you're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network, the exclusive home of Quinnipiac Athletics. Make sure you stop by at our website at theQBSN.com.
From the outside, the TD Bank Sports Center screams excitement. Inside, it's even louder. It's another season of hard-hitting Quinnipiac ice hockey and red-hot basketball, side-by-side in one of college sport's most amazing venues for fans. Check the schedule and get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. The Bobcats are making some noise this year. Are you? Yeah. Game on.
This is Jack McDonald, Director of Athletics at Quinnipiac University. On behalf of all of our student-athletes, coaches, and parents, we are very grateful to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network for broadcasting all our games all over the world to our Bobcat fans. Thank you, QBSN.
You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network, the official flagship station for volleyball, field hockey, rugby, and men's and women's soccer.
The all-new Bobcat Shop and Simplify Gift Shop by Campus Customs is now open just down the road at 1010 Sherman Avenue. Officially licensed Bobcat apparel and souvenirs in hundreds of styles, also featuring unique Simplify gift items like candy, jewelry, gourmet popcorn, apparel, and much more. Group screen printing and embroidery orders are also available and produced on the premises with low minimums and quick turnaround time. Visit our website at www.thebobcatshop.com.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, here to the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network as the voice of God himself, Kevin Noonan, commercial there for the Bobcat Shop. 1010 Sherman Avenue, stop in, say hi. But that's quite a bit of ways here. We're at the High Point Solutions Arena at the TD Bank Sports Center. After two periods of play, Quinnipiac and St. Lawrence tied at one apiece. Quick scoring summary for you folks tuning in at home. 6 minutes and 43 seconds into the second period. And on the power play, Riley Smith got her sixth of the season, assist there to Mel DeRochet. And then at 9 minutes and 24 seconds of the second period, on the power play as well, Kelly Babstock netted her 10th of the season from Sydney Roosler and Taryn Baumgart. So officially, Quinnipiac 1-for-1 on the power play and St. Lawrence 1-for-2. Bobcats out shooting St. Lawrence 28-12. And Kevin, when I say that, when you say a shot is a rocket, pretty much you would go to the dictionary and you would find a video of the Kelly Babstock goal from this afternoon so far.
Yeah, I think that's pretty safe to say Sid Roessler had the puck at the top right point, skated in towards the faceoff circle, switching spots with Cheyenne D'Arcangelo, and just fired a pass through the slot to a wide open Kelly Babstock and just one-timed it into the net. I mean, I haven't seen a shot that hard all year. Babstock absolutely ripped that shot. There was no chance that Carmen McDonald was going to make a save on that one, and if she did, it would probably be the save of the year as well. So, I mean,
she would Kelly probably Babstock have a a la Mighty Ducks, a puck mark.
Yes.
In the hand of her glove.
I think that's a fair assumption, Pete.
But, again, you look at the two teams and you look at the girls who have been getting most of the points for them. Riley Smith right there. And, again, you know, Kelly Babstock, you just can't say enough about what she's been able to do, not only for this team this year, but in her 4 years here as part of the program overall. But, again, with the absence of Erika Uden Johansson trying out for Team Sweden in the Olympics, she was the power play specialist for this team. Coach Rick Seeley probably after doing a little bit of tinkering with his lines when it comes to the power play. And I think pretty much what we've seen them try to do is try to open up Kelly Babstock on that backdoor opportunity. And we saw it pay off in UNH where Kelly Babstock had another strong slap shot as well, got her own rebound and was able to just lift it over the goalie of UNH. And tonight just paid dividends where that one-timer just flung itself right to the back of the net. And it tied this game up at one apiece. But not to take anything away from St. Lawrence, they came out at the start of that second period. They wanted to get the first goal in this one, and then indeed they did from Riley Smith on the power play. And it was another opportunity chance out in front. Layden makes the initial save, but Riley Smith all alone on the doorstep, a little bit of a defensive breakdown. So Coach Rick Seeley probably going to be telling his defense to focus on that as well. But certainly after the Bobcats tied it up, chances abounding on both sides for both teams. And as you alluded to, Kevin, in the middle of that period, when it became 1-1, it seemed that both of these teams finally were woken up, and they pretty much turned into an offensive showing of what these teams can do when they're at their best.
Yeah, it seemed like a switch kind of just turned on in the arena that both teams just started. It seemed like the intensity picked up, the skating was faster, even the physicality picked up too. Both teams becoming much more physical as time started winding down, and as the replay shows up on your computer screens, that's the Babstock power play goal, just a no-doubter from Babstock. But, you know, as I was saying before, every player on these teams just picked up in intensity. I mean, you can't talk about how much this game changed from the first period into the second period. It's just completely different, and if that's a kind of like a showing of what we're going to see in the third period, I can't wait for the third period to start.
Certainly settle in. Make a bag of popcorn if you're tuning in at home and buckle your seatbelts, because we are certainly indeed in for one heck of a third period between these two teams. But again, just alluding to what Chris Wells said before, when we talked to him after the first period, his team really needed to get their legs underneath them, and certainly that was the case. And it seemed as if when Quinnipiac went down 1-0, as you said, it seemed to find their legs underneath them, where they really probably said to themselves, this game's winding down, we're down a goal. And really, you know, we're the number 5 team in the country. We really need to start playing like it. And I think they responded well. And, again, coming out into the third period, I think it's going to be anybody's game.
Yeah, it seems like the last three games, Quinnipiac's kind of just gone through the motions in the first period. They've gotten plenty of shots, but there hasn't really been any, like, enthusiasm or intensity behind it. But here in the second period, as I said, turned up. And, you know, St. Lawrence got that goal. You have to think that definitely played a little bit of a factor into Quinnipiac getting that goal. I mean, anytime you get a power play opportunity like that and you find a wide open Kelly Babstock, you have to feed her right there. And I think that they just continue to get a lot of offensive opportunities in the second period. And they really didn't let St. Lawrence get too much offense going after that goal. So I think that, not that they've let St. Lawrence really got any offense going today, only 12 shots officially, scoring on one of them. But, you know, Chelsea Layden's been great in goal for the Bobcats, and Carmen McDonald's been probably even better, because facing 28 shots, she's had to work a lot more. And, you know, without Carmen McDonald, I think Quinnipiac would have a pretty substantial lead over St. Lawrence right now.
And after two periods of play, Clarkson now has a 5-0 lead in the women's game over Princeton. So certainly Clarkson going to be heading into Hamden tomorrow afternoon. little bit of their legs underneath them, and they are going to be primed and ready to go to face the number 5 team in the country in the Quinnipiac Bobcats. But that'll bring us to another quick commercial break here on the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network. We will be right back. Take a look ahead to the third period and what both of these teams needs to do to ensure they come out with the win column. You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network.
Hey, Bobcat fans, don't forget to go to www.theqbsn.com for live broadcasts, game stories, pictures, and more. TheQBSN.com offers you everything you need to know about the Bobcat teams you know and love. Again, go to TheQBSN.com, the online home for your favorite Quinnipiac sports.
Hey, Quinnipiac Bobcat fans. This is Billy Mecca from the Bobcat Sports Network. Please join us this season at the TD Bank Sports Center for some excellent men's and women's basketball and ice hockey games. The TD Bank Sports Center is the best facility in college athletics as it features family-friendly seating, prices, dates, and times. Please call area code 203-582-3905 or visit QuinnipiacBobcats.com to order your tickets now. Go Bobcats! Peace!
Hey, Bobcat fans, follow us on Twitter and Facebook for daily updates, reminders, and more from the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network, the online home for your favorite Quinnipiac sports.
Saturday night is hockey night here on theqbsn.com. Tune in at the conclusion of every Saturday men's or women's hockey broadcast for Hockey Night in Hamden. Join QBSN's finest hockey broadcasters, writers, and analysts as they break down the weekend that was Quinnipiac ice hockey. Discussions, debate, arguments, and the occasional five for fisticuffs all in a one-hour program live at theqbsn.com. Want something debated during the program? Well, email us at hockeynightinhamden@gmail.com or tweet at HamdenHKYNight. When overtime just isn't enough, we've got your extra hockey. So join us at theqbsn.com Saturdays following the last hockey broadcast for Hockey Night in Hamden, your exclusive Quinnipiac ice hockey talk show.
Ray and Mike's Deli, the deli destination for Quinnipiac athletics. Come and try the new Quick Witch named for Hamden's own Jonathan Quick. Also the fan favorites, the irresistible Mac Daddy and Steak and Cheese. Come in before or after the game, located at 3030 Whitney Ave. Cue cards are accepted.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, here to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network. Peter Rossi joined alongside by Kevin Noonan, waiting for the third period of action to start here in Hamden between the Quinnipiac Bobcats and the St. Lawrence Saints. They are tied one apiece just about minute 20 before the teams take back to the ice. Big QBSN basketball game the other night at Carneseca Place for St. John's. It was a tough one. We wound up failing in that one, but nonetheless, Zachary Daly had five fouls in the first quarter alone.
Who was surprised by that?
He was allowed. He was tossed early out of the game. Nonetheless, from the hard court to the ice, teams back out for the start of the third period. Quinnipiac in their alternate white jerseys, probably going to go with their golds tomorrow, which has been custom so far this season.
Well, how can you say it's the alternate? I think they're both alternates because they alternate days.
The new official white jersey.
The new official white jersey. I like it.
I do. Different than the white one they do sell, though, in the bookstore. But certainly, I feel it's better than the white ones that the men's team happens to wear from time to time. But the men's team opting to go with the third gold jerseys unveiled at last year's Yale game.
They've worn them in every game.
They've worn them in every game this season year. Because apparently the other jerseys haven't come in yet.
So, hey, I mean, you're winning in the yellows. Why
if
change?
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Indeed. St. Lawrence in their red and browns.
Can we just talk about the goalie pads of Carmen McDonald?
They are fantastic.
kind of looking more with the old school look but with a new school feel. I mean, I'm a big fan.
I am a very big fan as well.
And they've been very busy today.
Indeed they have. Faceoff is dropped here, start of the third period. 1-1 Quinnipiac and St. Lawrence. Bobcats get it in to the St. Lawrence defensive zone early in this one. Babstock trying to poke it away. Comes to D'Arcangelo. Up here for Babstock trying to walk out in front with it, but active sticks there for St. Lawrence. Roessler's shot goes off the back end. Comes back around for Babstock, trying to play it off the boards. D'Arcangelo now for Baumgard. Back for Roessler. Roessler, wrist shot gets deflected by McCray. Megan Turner trying to get it. Comes back to D'Arcangelo. D'Arcangelo, shot calmly guided away by McDonald. Babstock back for Baumgard to Roessler. Roessler, wrist shot, another block by McCray, and she will clear it out.
McCray's done very well with the stick blocks here on two Sid Roessler shots to start the third period.
Coach Rick Seeley probably wanting to see his sophomore defender wind up for that one-timer. Centering feet here, shot goes off the outside of the cage. Comes to Hahn now for St. Lawrence. Collin trying to get it. Hahn intercepts. This one sticked away by Layden into the near corner. Baumgard to play it for Nicole Brown. Gets intercepted almost by Marks. And Connery finds this puck kick off of her skate back down. Pedalis is out behind her own team's net. Circling a bit. She's watched there by Borgfeld. Doesn't really have any option to do with it. Eventually she works it back on the far side to Hahn. She then feeds it back to Pedalis, who trying to get it up out of the zone is Marks. Gets blocked by Woods. And Lindsay West now has it. She's going to clear it into the zone. And getting there first on the far side. Intercepted, though, by Fritz Ward. Centering feed here for D'Arcangelo. Rebound out in front. And this one is swiped up with the glove of Carmen McDonald. On the doorstep was Cheyenne D'Arcangelo. She had a wide open net. But Carmen McDonald saying, I don't think so.
Carmen McDonald put her glove on Cheyenne D'Arcangelo's stick and took that one right off the stick. A fantastic play made by McDonald. But before that, on the initial shot, D'Arcangelo wide open and a fantastic save by McDonald, really standing on her head today.
Wignall, wrist shot, deflected a bit. Opportunity here again for D'Arcangelo. Out behind, playing it back for Wignall. Back across now for Greco. Greco trying to go wide and get the rebound opportunity out back. Tripped up a bit, it's DeRochet. It comes back to Wignall, plays it back for Greco. Greco trying to go back down low for Babstock, no look. Backhand centering feed gets intercepted by Wilkinson, and St. Lawrence now looks to counterattack. Wilkinson gets it around Greco, comes to Wignall. Wignall and Wand crunching into the boards. D'Arcangelo plays it up for Babstock. Babstock has Turner trying to connect. Turner will get there though. She's pinned now. Back behind by Krakenidis. Turner trying to escape with it. Krakenidis still trying to get her active stick in. Turner off the boards around for Baumgard. Baumgard shot, deflected, chance out in front. But again, Quinnipiac, no players there in the slot. St. Lawrence doing a nice job of taking away those opportunities. Nicole Brown pokes this one around. DeRochet. Krakenidis has it. Protecting, skating out in front. Trying to play it up for McCray. And McCray is just going to lift this one into the Bobcats' end. Baumgard watched there by Webster. Webster, nice couple of moves to put on the brakes. Out in front here, Brown's opportunity gets intercepted there from the errant stick down in the near corner. And Roessler trying to get this one out, and Brown is able to do so. 16:28 left to go in the third period. Not many stoppages so far in this period. 1-1, teams are tied. Borgfeld far side trying to get the pass off, trying to go back around now for Fritz Ward. Fritz Ward, nice protection, looking at her options, going down low. Borgfeld back to the blue line for West. West fakes the shot, trying to go for the pass for Fritz Ward. It comes to Emma Woods. Emma Woods almost collides there with Borgfeld. And now it's St. Lawrence that retains possession, but nice intercept there by West. She's trying to play it out in front. Fritz Ward, a shot, rebound here, diving, trying to get it. Was Woods. McDonald to go. McDonald still vigilant in her crease. Here's Babstock now. Checked a bit. Still trying to get it off to one of her line mates. Eventually it comes to Riley Smith. This one pickpocketed by Megan Turner. And Megan Turner bumped a bit there by Alex Moore. It comes back around. D'Arcangelo in the far corner. D'Arcangelo escapes with it, trying to get the shot, gets blocked off of her skate. Babstock, backhander, another chance here. Check that, Turner. Babstock, no, feeds it back to Turner. Excuse me, Greco at the blue line, but McDonald again, having her glove, she scoops this one up.
Great job right there by the Bobcats, continuing to put the pressure on the goaltender of the Saints, Carmen McDonald, now getting up to 33 shots unofficially in the game. So great job by the Bobcats. And, you know, both teams looking to break this tie, and right now Quinnipiac continues to hold the advantage in the offensive end. St. Lawrence really unable to do anything so far.
Baumgart looking at one of the players out in front was Connery trying to work it too. Connery now pinned to the boards, trying to help her out. Colin. Colin, no look, centering feet, gets out of the zone. We've seen that come back to bite the Bobcats a couple of times this afternoon. Connery trying to get this one away from Marks. Now St. Lawrence, an errant pass, gets intercepted by Roessler. Colin trying to play this one. Marks tangled up a bit. Connery still can't get anything on it. Connery, though, intercepts. Trying to go down on one knee, trying to prevent it from getting out of the zone. Connery still has it. Centering feed goes off of the stick of McDonald, and a favorable bounce there comes to St. Lawrence. This one knocked away by Tamberg. Comes to Roessler at her own blue line. Playing it for Brackett. Brackett fighting that puck all afternoon. Whiffs on that opportunity. Comes now to Pedalis. Pedalis trying to go off the backboards. Woods on the forecheck. It comes back to Pedalis. Now she's watched by Brackett. Pedalis trying to slow it down. Takes a favorable bounce there off the end boards. Here's Webster shot into the glove of Chelsea Layden. And she will hold with 14:05 left to go in the third period. Still tied at one.
Chelsea Layden, great job following the puck as Brooke Webster skated in on the right side. Layden moving a little bit over, hugging the inside post, and had no problem making that glove save. But what a big save that is for Layden.
Webster has it for St. Lawrence. Back to shot there from the point by DeRochet. Goes wide. Comes to Hahn on the far boards for Webster. Loses this one a bit to Babstock. Roessler now joins the fray. Roessler gets dumped by Webster behind the net. Webster has a little bit of room there. Maybe get a centering feed going, but eventually she loses it to Baumgart. Roessler can't get anything on it. Shot here into the crease. This one poked away by Baumgart. And it comes to Babstock. Babstock whiffs on the initial attempt, trying to play it back for Roessler. Roessler will collect, losing it a bit. And this one taken by Smith. Riley Smith, slap shot into the crest there of Chelsea Layden, so she will hold. Just about a minute has passed since that last whistle. Still one apiece. Faceoff will be to the left of Chelsea Layden.
Quick update from Princeton, New Jersey. The Clarkson Golden Knights still hold a 5-0 advantage over the Princeton Tigers. Jamie Lee-Retray leading the offense with 1 goal and 3 assists, and Ambrose 1 goal and 2 assists.
Popped up in the air. Chelsea Layden is out to hold it onto her glove. So the Bobcats having some difficulties now trying to get possession of that puck in their own zone and skate it out. St. Lawrence doing a nice job of keeping it in, trying to get that leading goal.
And also in action tonight, a matchup of top 10 teens, Boston University taking on Harvard at 7 p.m. on the women's side.
Shelby Wignall for the Bobcats trying to fire this one out. Borgfeld almost getting it. Comes back into the Bobcat zone. Wignall held a bit there, trying to get it away from Ranewski. Ranewski in the near corner, protecting. Nice drop off there from Marks. This one poked away by Quinnipiac. Wignall trying to play it off the boards, and it will come to Amanda Collin. Nice move there by Amanda Collin into the zone. She shoots it. McDonald saves it. Didn't know where it was, so she's just going to hunch over and make sure it doesn't happen to pop out loose for a Bobcat rebound.
Yeah, Amanda Collin with a great move to get around the St. Lawrence defender, and right there had a pretty open shot. Was unable to really tuck it away into a corner right into the crest of McDonald.
Bobcats poked the puck off the faceoff circle to the Saints, so it's Moore trying to play it around for Pedalis. She's watched there by Emma Woods. Almost skates into trouble. She skated it into the net. Shot here, saved by McDonald as Fritz Ward was right in front. Puck trickled right to her stick. McDonald, though, makes the save.
McDonald continuing to make save after save right there. Fritz Ward right on the doorstep was ready to put that one home, but McDonald gets herself in position and really no chance as McDonald has just been fantastic.
Here's a chance. Puck gets deflected out just to the top of the blue paint, but Bobcats not be able to do anything with it. Here's Turner now. Daylight turn. This one gets deflected just wide. Babstock was able to get it under the pad of McDonald again. The puck just trickling to the side. Here's D'Arcangelo circling in the neutral zone. Loses an edge. She's able to get it to Turner, but Turner finds this one roll off her stick to Williams. At the home blue line. Baumgard trying to clear this one in. Goes off the skate of Wand. So Williams is out to play it. Wilkinson lets this one just go back around to Roche. Shot here. Gets blocked out in front by Wilkinson. On the doorstep was Collin. Greco takes this one. Waits for the Bobcats to get on sides. Greco still deep in the zone. Trying to get the centering feed. Trickling it yet again. Nicole Brown now losing it to Wilkinson. Wilkinson chips this one all the way around. Wignall, a pinch on the far side. Wignall trying to get the indecision there, but eventually it now comes back to Quinnipiac as it's Connery. Connery trying to get the deflection there with Wignall and popped up into the mesh out behind. That'll bring the faceoff out of the zone with 11:12 left to go in the third period. Quinnipiac and St. Lawrence 1-1.
Throughout the game, it looks like Nicole Connery's been kind of skating away from the goal and taking a little bit of a weak wrist. I know she's trying to create some room, but it hasn't always worked out for her, and right there it just gets deflected into the screen.
Fritz Ward trying to get something off of it, but now here's St. Lawrence. The numbers if they hurry. McCray into the zone. Slow trickler in on goal by Layden. A little bit of an extra push there by Webster after Layden covered up on it. Nothing too serious, but that will keep the faceoff in the Bobcats' end.
Right there, Layden ready to pounce on that puck, keep it away. The score is still tied 1-1. Both teams trying to break through, but no one able to do so yet.
Puck here, intercepted by Cheyenne D'Arcangelo. Skates it into the zone, trying to get the centering pass. D'Arcangelo shoots, just goes over the glove of McDonald. She was trying to pick that top corner. Baumgard finds this one poked away. Pedalis watched there by Megan Turner. Weak puck slowly going towards the blue line. Babstock trying to hold it in, but she can't. So now it comes to Webster. Webster trying to skate around Roessler. She has some room in the near corner, loses the puck a bit. So it comes all the way back around for Sydney Roessler. Trying to get it to Babstock in the neutral zone. Babstock into the zone, shoots, and held there by McDonald. Safe play there by Babstock. She just wants to get the face off in the St. Lawrence zone with 10:22 left to go in the third period.
Wilkinson and DeRoche really shutting down the defensive line, not giving Babstock any room to go in and, you know, as you said, weak wrister and keeps the faceoff in the Bobcat zone.
Alex Moore will skate with it for the Saints. Knocked down in the neutral zone by Collin, circling with it now. Was Riley Smith, dropped off for DeRoche, connecting up front with Ranewski. Ranewski taken down on the play by Greco, and that will be a penalty against the Bobcats' freshman defender. Tripping is the call. So the Bobcats will go to the penalty kill with 10 minutes and 1 second left to go in the second period. Oh, excuse me, third period. Bobcats' penalty kill, 1-for-2 so far in the afternoon. Excuse me, 2-for-2.
Right there, Emma Greco's stick getting hung up in the St. Lawrence defender, and really nothing she could do about it. At that point, it was too late to pull the stick away. As she pulled it away, got the tripping penalty, so another power play opportunity for St. Lawrence.
Tamberg loses this one to Webster down behind the goal. Back to the blue line, it comes for Williams. Slap shot goes wide, comes to Ranewski in the near corner. Back to the blue line for Pedalis. Feeds it back to Ranewski, a little bit of trouble. Back to the blue line, slithering across here. Williams, this one blocked. Babstock trying to get a chance here. Shorthanded, what a move by Babstock. She's into the zone, protecting. It's gonna be a delayed penalty call. And it's going to be holding.
Max.
So Kelly Babstock, strong play, shorthanded, draws the penalty as she was skating in to Kirsten Pedalis. And that will bring the teams to some 4-on-4 action now for a minute and 31. And then the Bobcats will have the abbreviated power play.
Second holding penalty today on St. Lawrence. Last time the Saints took a penalty, it led to a Bobcat goal. We'll see how the fortune fares this time.
4-on-4 action here. Bobcats and Saints. McCray, far side, watched there by Collin. It comes out to Riley Smith. Smith trying to put some speed, trying to get past the Bobcats defense. Baumgard trying to poke this one away. McCray trying to keep it in. McCray losing sight of it. She had marks all alone, but lost sight of the puck. Roessler works it up to Connery. Bobcats 3-on-2 if they hurry. Connery into the zone, has a couple of options. Trying to get the centering feed, knocked down by Marks. Comes back around. Riley Smith has it now for St. Lawrence. Riley Smith, this one, sticked away by Amanda Collin. Roessler circles with it, playing it back for Connery. Connery thought twice about passing it to Collin. Bobcats go for the line change. 39 seconds left to go in the 4-on-4 play. 8:37 left to go in the third period. Both teams still trying to get the second goal of the game as they're knotted up at one apiece. Taken here by Alex Moore now for the Saints. Moore into the zone, watched by Lindsay West. West puts herself into the boards. Nice job there to get around. This one up high into the air, and Layden will just glove this down, try to get some setup for her team as they were chasing themselves around in their own zone. 8:16 left to go in the third period.
Only 15 seconds remaining on the penalty of Emma Greco, which will then give the Bobcats 29 seconds on the power play. So Bobcats are going to get ready for 29 seconds of probably a pretty ferocious 5-on-4 attack.
Shot there from the faceoff circle. Layden gets the save. Stick check there by Wignall. Out in front. Save me. Layden kicks it out. Chance here. Tamberg trying to get the home run pass to Babstock. This one knifed down, though, by Wilkinson. And it's going to be delayed offsides on the Bobcats. 4-on-4 is over, so the Bobcats will have the short power play for 27 seconds. 1-1 here score in Hamden. Faceoff will be brought just outside to the Bobcats' defensive zone.
Now Quinnipiac putting out the top power play unit with Kelly Babstock, Shine D'Arcangelo, and joining them Sid Roessler, Emma Woods, and Taryn Baumgard. So Bobcats getting ready, looking for that onslaught.
This is the power play unit that tied the game up at one. So Rick Seely hoping that this five can do it again. 18 seconds left to go. Bobcats trying to get the rush going. D'Arcangelo, nice job to get a stick on it. So with no icing against her team, comes back around. This one gets knocked down by the Bobcats. 8 seconds left to go on the power play. Babstock, far side, trying to get the centering feed. Goes through the crease, comes back to the blue line for Baumgard. Team's back to 5-on-5, but the Bobcats trying to set something up. Protecting it on that one was D'Arcangelo, but eventually she lost it. Now it's Hahn for the Saints, watched by Emma Woods. Puck slowly into the Bobcats' end. Five players bunching up with it. Trickles out of the Bobcats' end. This one almost intercepted by D'Arcangelo, but now it comes to Baumgard. She gets the weak dump and change for the Bobcats. Pass here off the boards comes for Tamberg. Tamberg's pass is intercepted there by Ranewski, but Lindsay West pokes this one away. Tamberg now protecting in the near corner, trying to fire it out, referee ducking. And it comes to Lindsay West. Nice job there to fake the backhand clear and then take it all by herself. Brown trying to play it up for Connery. 2-on-1 here for the Bobcats if they hurry. Connery has it. Connery takes the shot, goes off the handle of the stick of McDonald as Connery was trying to get that toe drag and, again, go top shelf on McDonald. Chancy enough for Riley Smith. This one knocked away by Greco. Riley Smith will just get the backhand down and get her teammates the line change. Comes back around now. Nicole Brown trying to feed it out. Collin watches this one go right by her in the neutral zone. Wilkinson plays it for Desrochers. Desrochers trying to get forecheck going for the Saints. Comes to Wand. Wand watched by Wignall. Williams had some trouble with it. Wignall intercepts and just clears it out. Circling with it is Wilkinson, watched there by Fritz Ward. Now here's Wand. She has some room change for the Bobcats. They could get caught. Her shot goes off the outside of the cage. Fritz Ward, weak backhander, popping all around. Borgfeld trying to get it out. Pinned there a bit by McCray. Now it comes to Wignall. Wignall watched by McCray. Collin able to outstretch and poke this one out of the zone. 5:35 left to go in the third period. Team still tied 1-1. Desrochers in the far corner pops this one up high, but D'Arcangelo, fresh off the bench, circles with it, works it back for Baumgard, trying to play it up to Turner. She loses it, and it comes to Webster. This one poked off of Webster by D'Arcangelo. And St. Lawrence slowly puts this one in the Bobcats' end. Baumgard, though, her errant pass gets intercepted by Webster. Webster trying to get the centering feed. Gets blocked by Baumgard. Comes to Moore. Moore trying to work it back around for Webster. She's pinned there by Roessler. Baumgard now trying to get that puck loose. A couple players still trying to bang away at it. Referee is right there, so he can blow the whistle if he wants, if that puck does not happen to move out of that corner. And indeed, it will be blown by the official at center ice instead. Nonetheless, that freezes play as that puck was not coming loose. 4:43 left to go in the third period. 1-1, Bobcats and Saints.
Just to update you from Princeton, New Jersey, it's now 7-0 Clarkson. They've put two more goals here in the third period.
And Clarkson, indeed, the team that the Bobcats will be welcoming to Hamden tomorrow afternoon for another ECAC matinee matchup. Tamberg just to the right of Chelsea Layden, trying to get it out now of the Bobcats. St. Lawrence now knifes it down. Brown having some trouble getting it out. It comes to Marks. Nice job to protect. Eventually it does come back to Lindsay West, and she's going to try and chip this one out. Held by McCray. Bobcats banging away at it. Brown puts her body into it, and eventually the Bobcats are able to escape with it into their own zone. Tamberg plays it up for Brown, trying to get the quick pass there for Connery. But again, the Saints will just intercept and look to break themselves into the Bobcat zone. Alex Moore's pass gets blocked a bit. D'Arcangelo trying to catch the Saints in a change. Errant pass there. She's racing after it. Wilkinson puts on the brakes. Safe play going back to DeRochet. This one knifed down by Roessler, and Riley Smith will just clear this one in. Layden watches this one go right by her paddle. Comes back to Baumgard, trying to play it around for Roessler. D'Arcangelo trying to slow it down from DeRochet. She's now in a battle there with Roessler in the near corner. Riley Smith finds Baumgard just poking this one away. Megan Turner trying to play it out for Babstock. Babstock able to get a stick on it into the zone. Looking at her options, trying to play it to herself. Babstock still protecting. Nice job to put on the brakes. Babstock has it, trying to work it out in front. She has it. Weak shot there. Save made by McDonald with the right pad. D'Arcangelo now had her stick held a bit. Turner now pinned to the boards, trying to escape with it. D'Arcangelo has it, trying to play it out in front. But the Saints will take it. Babstock trying to get this one away. Nice move there to get around everybody by DeRochet. Tamberg will take. Skate around Chelsea Layden, watched there a bit, comes to Fritz Ward. 2:30 left to go in the third period, 1-1 between the Bobcats and St. Lawrence. Pedalis, watched by Borgfeld, plays it around to Williams. Williams' weak opportunity, not being able to get all the way out, gets gloved down. Quick chance here, almost on the doorstep, but just getting a piece of the blocker on it was McDonald. DeRochet. Long shift for her, trying to be played. Takes a bounce out in front, but again, the Bobcats don't have anybody parked out in front. And there's a strong check by Sydney Roessler in front of the Bobcats bench. It's going to be body checking on Jacqueline Wand. And the Bobcats will go to the penalty kill with exactly 2 minutes left to go in the third period. And this could very well be the game if St. Lawrence is able to get one here.
Absolutely huge penalty taken or committed right there by Sid Roessler, getting the body checking penalty with exactly 2 minutes left. That's going to put St. Lawrence on the power play for the final 2 minutes of the game. And, you know, the way this offense has really turned on, see if they can take advantage of this opportunity.
St. Lawrence wins the faceoff. DeRochet has time to walk in with it, playing it down low for chance out in front here, playing it down low for McCray, but escaping with it now shorthanded is Connery. She's going to skate it down, kill some time off the clock, so a strong start for the Bobcats. Comes to DeRochet for St. Lawrence. Backhander, Layden watches this one go wide. Wignall, slap shot, trying to get it out. It comes to Babstock. Babstock has it, but she loses it and then loses an edge, so she has to go pick up her stick. So the Bobcats re-up now on the shorthanded opportunities. Wilkinson watched by Babstock in the neutral zone. Comes back to DeRochet. DeRochet trying to go backdoor for Alex Moore. Moore can't corral that pass in, but she does escape it with it a bit, but Wignall is able to knock her off. Wignall taken down a bit. No call on that one, as it was could have been tripping on the Saints. Rick Seeley still up in arms now off of that one. Final minute of play in the third period. 52 seconds left to go on St. Lawrence power play. Bouncing puck, trouble there from McCray. Greco is going to play this one. Try to play it to Babstock. Shorthanded. Kelly Babstock in the zone. Check there a bit. Does possession. Babstock is going to escape with it. Babstock takes the shot. Rebound out in front. D'Arcangelo. And her shot just goes wide. Bobcats need to hurry up and skate back down with it. Tamberg settles things down, playing it to Baumgart. Baumgart trying to play it up for Connery. Connery just watching this one. One of the officials had his hand up as to signal an icing. Not really sure he knows where he is. 15 seconds left to go in the third period. Baumgart gets tangled up a bit. 10 seconds left to go on the kill to St. Lawrence. Trying to get it into the zone is Williams, watched by Tamberg. This one goes all the way around. Ranewski is there. Comes all the way around. And the buzzer will sound, and the Bobcats kill it off. But that will end regulation, so the Bobcats and Saints will head to overtime, tied 1-1. But again, the Bobcats, the prime opportunity to get the second goal. Babstock shorthanded. What protection of the puck. She gets a shot off. McDonald is there, and then the rebound to Cheyenne D'Arcangelo, not able to put it home.
I don't know how she kept in control of that puck. It looked like she was going to lose it at the blue line when there's two sticks coming in at her, but somehow she put on a little extra burst of speed, got past the defense, and then Carmen McDonald stuffing her at the on the doorstep of the goal. But then Cheyenne D'Arcangelo unable to put home the rebound when she had a wide open left side of the net. So, you know, great job by Carmen McDonald right there as she stopped unofficially 42 of 43 shots. So, you know, but Pete, let's be real. Are we surprised that this game is going to overtime between St. Lawrence and Quinnipiac after all they went through in the ECAC quarterfinals last year?
I mean, you look at the way both of these teams play, and certainly from the defensive side of things to the goalies to the forwards, despite what Chris Wells said, his team losing a ton of talent from last year, and despite things, they're still sitting pretty in the middle of the ECAC. The replay is now being shown. Kelly Babstock with the initial save, and then D'Arcangelo probably would have netted that one home, but Riley Smith, as she was falling down, reached back and got a stick on it, preventing Cheyenne D'Arcangelo from getting an attempt on it. So that just goes to show the immense smarts that Riley Smith has when it comes to the game.
Just shows
hockey.
How important these players feel that this win is. I mean, like we said at the beginning of the game, throughout the game, 3-6 in the ECAC women's standings are separated by just a point, with three teams tied at 8, which is St. Lawrence, Quinnipiac, and Princeton, and Clarkson right behind that at 7. So it's pretty much a jumble in the middle of the ECAC, and you think, and both these teams are really coming out here, and they want this win. You can see it in the intensity that we've seen through the last two periods. Neither team wants to go home with a loss, and neither team probably wants to go home with a tie either.
So Babstock and McCray, two of the best forwards on the ice for each respective team, are going to take the faceoff to start off the five-minute overtime period. First team to score wins, and if nobody scores at the end of the 5 minutes, it will be a tie. Quinnipiac gets possession of the pucks to start things off, but Babstock not able to get anything on that pass, but eventually comes back to her far side, looking at her options, back to the blue line for Baumgart. Weak shot there, just trying to play it back in deep. Megan Turner trying to get it to D'Arcangelo. Now it comes to Babstock, tied up there a bit. DeRochet trying to get around. Baumgart, here's a chance, 3-on-1 for St. Lawrence. Here's Webster into the zone. She has it. Chance here, just goes wide of the cage. Probably thinking twice, she should have shot, but now here's Kelly Babstock for the Bobcats. Slap shot blocked away by McDonald. Megan Turner trying to keep the attack alive. Wilkinson losing the edge, comes to Brown. Brown puts on the brakes, playing it into the near corner. Turner playing it back in as she was going to the bench for a change. Comes to Nicole Connery. Loose opportunity there. Collin now has it, trying to keep it in. This one will be fed up to Webster. Webster trying to get around Tamberg, but Connery coming to her aid. It'll be played out to Collin. Amanda Collin not being able to get an edge on that one. She called for it and then not really able to do anything with it. So with 3 minutes and 52 seconds left to go in the overtime, Fayette will be brought back down to the Bobcat zone, but St. Lawrence, the early opportunity to win it, a 3-on-1, and Brooke Webster not able to finish off.
That was an absolutely big play right there with the St. Lawrence unable to take advantage of that 3-on-1 opportunity.
Now here's Amanda Collin for the Bobcats, 3-on-2. Collin has it, centering feet here, just goes wide. Brown trying to get the tip in. Lindsey West trying to play it back to Nicole Brown. Looks at her options, plays it back for Amanda Collin, losing it a bit. Brown trying to keep this one in. Eventually it's played up. Goes off the skate of Fritz Ward. Now St. Lawrence re-ups with it. Rebound off the backboards. Hahn trying to get it. She's watched by Greco. Hahn still trying to protect. Bobcats have people on the doorstep. Collin, though, gets that puck on the interception, is able to clear it out. Leighton, a chance here, a save out in front, falling with it, trying to get it out is Fritz Ward. Here's a shot, gets blocked out in front by Greco. Greco and Ranewski now on the far side. Juan trying to help out. Fritz Ward now again. Nicole Brown takes this one with her glove, and she clears it out. 2:50 left to go in the overtime period. Into the zone now, it's Wilkinson. Wilkinson trying to slow things down, wait for some reinforcements from the bench, but this one poked away by Greco. Now it's Megan Turner trying to play this one. This one poked away by Wignall. Turner still has it, trying to get it away from Williams. And this one able to be played deeper into the zone by Heidersbach. Comes around far side for D'Arcangelo. D'Arcangelo trying to play it to Turner. Can't corral this one in, and now here's another opportunity here for St. Lawrence. They skate in. Shot goes wide of the cage. Heidersbach takes it, trying to power her way to the front. Chance here in front, a couple of chances, and Leighton flat on the ice, stoning it, keeping that puck out of the back of her net.
Chelsea Leighton really proving the backstop that she really is, just holding her own right there, right on the goal line, not letting any Saints really poke away at it and jar it loose, and was able to hold on long enough to get the whistle.
Bobcats trying to get it out. It comes to Webster. Webster centering feet here. Shot fanning on it was Riley Smith. Bobcats again trying to get it out. Comes to Babstock trying to play it off the boards for Woods. Woods and Babstock reunited after Woods was dropped down to that third line in favor of Cheyenne D'Arcangelo moving up to the first line. A couple of loose possessions of the puck. Woods trying to get it out. Can't get it away from Pedalis. Eventually Woods still trying to get it out. It's held at the blue line by Webster, and Moore escapes with it. Trying to go from her backhand to her forehand was Riley Smith. This one trying to get the centering feed there, but it comes and pops out to Babstock. Kelly Babstock for Quinnipiac can't get this one around Pedalis, and she clears it back in. Leighton is out to slow it down for Baumgard, and Baumgard, weak attempt there around the boards. It gets picked off by Hahn. Hahn has it. Watch there. It comes out in front. Save made by Leighton, poking away at it after was Ranewski, and then Ranewski gets a bump put on her by Sydney Roessler. Roessler probably not happy that she was taking a couple of extra shots there at her goalie.
Yeah, Bobcat standing up for Chelsea Leighton right there, sending Ranewski to the ground. So, I mean, roughly about the final minute of overtime play, and the intensity hasn't slowed down since both teams scored in the second period. It's been high-flying action ever since then, and it looks like Rick Seeley is going to call his timeout here in the overtime period.
Rick Steele probably wanting to just settle his girls down here with just over a minute 16 left to go in the overtime period. And the only thing about this, though, is that you give the other team a chance to try and work out a play if they do happen to win the faceoff. But quick scoring summary for you folks tuning in at home. All the scoring so far happened in the second period of this one. 6 minutes and 43 seconds in. Riley Smith, her sixth of the season from Mel DeRochet. And then at 9 minutes and 24 seconds of the second period on the power play, Kelly Babstock from Sydney Roessler and Taryn Baumgarten. Pretty much other than that, these teams have been very stout defensively. They've had their offensive chances, but both goalies as well standing tall in between the pipes.
Yeah, both goalies. They've been the story of this game so far, despite the two fantastic goals scored by each team. Without Carmen McDonald and without Chelsea Lane, this is a completely different game. Carmen McDonald is, you could pretty much say she stood on her head in this one. Roughly 44 saves in the game so far. And Chelsea Leighton, although she's only hasn't seen as nearly as many shots as McDonald. St. Lawrence has had a plethora of excellent scoring opportunities.
Chance here for St. Lawrence. It gets kicked out. Slap shot from the blue line gets blocked by D'Arcangelo. D'Arcangelo trying to play at the Babstock. She just watches this one go right by her, though, but it gets intercepted by D'Arcangelo. Cheyenne D'Arcangelo into the zone. She has it, takes the shot, gets blocked. Hahn picks it up, trying to play it around for her defensive partner. Final minute of play in the overtime period. 53 seconds left to go in the period. Baumgart, or check that, Roessler, trying to clear this one in. After it is Wilkinson, still watched by Babstock. Babstock gets a piece of this one. It comes back to Ranewski. Ranewski now watched by Connery. This one pops out. Roessler trying to just get this rolling puck out of the zone. Comes back to Cindy Roessler. She loses it, though, to Ranewski. Diving after it was Baumgart. Ranewski loses it a bit. Gets it back to the blue line. Shot here by Marks. Gets blocked by Connery. She plays it up. 22 left to go in the period. Collin into the zone. Collin shoots. Rebound out in front. Taken down after it. Rolling puck. It's still loose on the side of the cage. But Kelly Babstock was taken down just as that play ended. 10 seconds left to go in the period. Riley Smith plays it off to Brooke Webster. Webster's shot gets deflected. Just goes through the crease. Far side it comes to Moore. Tamberg takes it, and the horn's going to sound. So the Bobcats and Saints tie 1-1 in this one, and slow to get up is Marks. As she still is favoring, it seems, her leg after that one, but both goalies are congratulated by their teams, as certainly they were the two top players in this game, as you said, Kevin, unofficially. Chelsea Layden making 23 saves and Carmen McDonald making 45. But again, as you said, going into this one, could you expect anything less than a tight defensive goal-minded game? 1-1 tie here between the Bobcats and the Saints. Really, if you look at the tail of the tape between these two teams, it really shouldn't come as a shock to anyone, but again, both teams will probably be happy to get with the point.
Yeah, I think anytime you have a hard-fought game like this, you have to be happy to come away with the point. But, I mean, at the same token, with the amount of opportunities both teams had offensively, they each had a lot of strong offensive opportunities. And I think there's going to be a little bit of disappointment that neither team was able to get more than one goal. But that's just from strictly a coaching standpoint, where you always want to come away with the victory. And I think if you're St. Lawrence, you come away from this one happy to get the 1 point, because it keeps you in the upper part of the ECAC standings. But for the Quinnipiac Bobcats, you kind of think they've come out a little slow the last 3 weeks, or last three games, I should say, where they were able to get in the last week, and they're able to get two late third period goals, which would prove to be the difference. But tonight they weren't able to get that late third period magic, and I think Rick Seeley might be a little bit disappointed with the result. But like I said, you can't be disappointed to get at least 1 point out of the game.
And the updated standings after the action of today: Cornell still with 14, Harvard behind them with 13, Quinnipiac, St. Lawrence, and Clarkson now in a three-way tie with 9 points, and Princeton with those 8 points drops down below those three teams. Quinnipiac will go to 10-1-4, 3-1-3 in the ECAC, and St. Lawrence will go to 6-7-0 overall, 4-2-1 in the ECAC. We will take a quick commercial break on the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network. Come back with your full game recap and a look ahead to tomorrow between the Bobcats and the Clarkson Golden Knights.
I'm Matthias Gauss, and you're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network.